it in a movie full of juicy people. Wow! It's a trap! Help! It's Pick! We've had it, men.
A pleasant aroma for you, but not for mosquitoes. Pick is easy to use. Light it and forget it. The exclusive aluminum-lined ashtray top means not an ash falls on the dash. Pick's aroma keeps mosquitoes, gnats, and sandflies away. Pick is the best protection for barbecues, fishing and camping trips, or just relaxing in the yard. No more sleepless nights or mosquito bites. Pick is harmless to children and pets, too.
So if you don't want our company ever anywhere, just light Pick and see what I mean? Bye.
Pick is on sale at the refreshment station. Something different for a change? Then try the perfect refreshment. Chili Dilly, a delicious pickle treat that's spiced just right for every bite. Economical, too. There's no waste. You eat every bit of the juicy goodness of Chili Dilly. How about trying one right now? Chili Dilly, on sale at our concession stand. You'll love them.
You have 10 minutes till showtime. 10, 9, 8, 7 minutes to go. You have 5 minutes till showtime. Oh. Only 2 minutes left.
Everybody's crazy. Papa goes the weasel. Everybody knows the weasel blows. But popcorn, she pops real good. I eat popcorn. Everybody eats popcorn. She tastes real nice. Get yourself some now at our refreshment stand.
It's showtime.
Thank you. We have just seen rushes direct from Hollywood of pictures being released in the coming weeks. And we are proud to announce that this theater will soon bring you the greatest array of pictures ever to reach our screen. You'll see the finest stars in exciting performances. You'll thrill to the suspense, comedy, romance, and drama of world-famous stories. Here's a glimpse of a few of them coming to this theater soon.
Please remember to replace the speaker on the post when you leave the theater.
Scumbags, losers, killers, and haters of this world. Evil must be punished.
Chris Von Helton, Von Helton, Von Helton, Von Helton hates the grace, the gays, evil ways, Illuminates. Von Helton, Von Helton, Von Helton, Von Helton hates gangsters.
Every buzzy listen really close. Look at Von Helton about to make a toast. Do a video, tell us the status quo, and then it'll post, cause that's how it goes. That's how he rolls on his TV live show. I know you know you dig the Von Helton flow. It's time to move like both of our posts. So baby, let's go. It's the Von Helton show.
Von Helton, Von Helton, Von Helton, Von Helton hates the grace, the gays, evil ways. Illuminates, Von Helton, Von Helton, Von Helton, Von Helton hates gangsters and gangs, lizard eggs, and gangbang rapes.
Tick-a-tack-tack, Von Helton is back from the dead, he rose again, standing in the flesh, what you didn't expect. Please show some respect or get the tech pressed up against your neck, and you'll never forget one word that he said, or you're gonna regret that you didn't sit and ponder. Von said you don't wanna mess with these really big iguanas.
Von Helton, Von Helton, Von Helton, Von Helton hates the grace, the gays, the ways, Illuminates. Von Helton, Von Helton, Von Helton, Von Helton hates gangsters and gangs, lizard eggs, and gangbang rapes.
Now it's verse 3, I'ma rip it up wrong. Don't mess with Bone or you're gonna be gone. He's not a bad guy, don't get on his bad side. He'll do Palpatine and make you join the dark side. He'll make you die, he'll bruise you right out. So now one side is a blur half the time. Bone battled some demons, we need to get some lives. Cause all they do is fight a bunch of dead guys. You can smell these guys from miles like flies. And the body odor is vile, surprise. He dies all the time, that's how he realized he has a great future that'll benefit mankind.
Von Helton, Von Helton, Von Helton, Von Helton hates the grace, the gays, evil ways, Illuminates. Von Helton, Von Helton, Von Helton, Von Helton hates gangsters and gangs, lizard eggs, and gangbang rapes.
Ladies and gentlemen. If you're receiving my transmission, let me know if you hear me out there. We're doing a little different tonight. It's a big step for... I'm not old enough to be a boomer. No, I'm not even close to being a boomer. A sub-boomer, technically challenged Gen Xer. We're running StreamYards through OBS. We're double wrapping it for our protection tonight because I am having a guest. Folks, thank you for joining me. It's been a while since we've done a Von Helton Theater. And I want to thank you all for joining me. Just one quick sec. All right. So I'll go over here and I'll mute myself because I should have a guest waiting in the wings here. Let's see if they have shown up yet, folks. Make sure to let me know. We got Miracle Mike adding to the stream now. Oh my goodness, he looked like someone that should be giving me a quest. Well, let me just hang on just a sec because I don't know if they can hear you. Let me go. Give a test now. Give me a test. Miracle Mike.
Can you hear me? Coming in hot.
All right. Should be going through OBS now. Yeah, I was just saying, yeah, we got Miracle Mike. I love that picture of Mike with the stick, the walking stick.
Right. That's 100% he has a golden question mark above his head. He's a quest giver, 100%.
He's just sitting there with his knees bending up and down over and over again.
If that would fit, I would use that, but unfortunately it's too detailed.
All right, I just want to make sure. I know that there's some lag out there, folks, but give me a confirmation everything's coming through good. Good, all that stuff. So we're just gonna riff on some fucking old videos from the vault. I don't even know. I grabbed some as people saw. I'm gonna try to play them through StreamYard. I'm trying new things here, folks. But so we're gonna see how that works. So we're just gonna. Who knows where we're gonna end up tonight? Could be fucking crazy. We don't know.
Gonna be one of those kind of parties, you know.
Mm-hmm.
If you're not having a good time, you just stick your dick in the mashed potatoes.
Mm-hmm. That's how we do it. So apparently Von Helton was live over on DLive earlier. I don't know if it was just his rock and roll show, but I guess we can confirm he's been informed. I am now a brother in arms with Von Helton, a member of the 1st Cavalry Division. And actually, what the hell?
Hello, soldier.
I'm proud. I don't know about him. I don't know what his problem is, but I'm actually a proud member, associate member, just to be clear. I want to hold that there.
Oh, I mean, it's laminated. I mean, that is 100%.
You totally official. Just can't go to a print shop and make that yourself.
No, that's impossible. That has to be made by government machinery. 100%.
He says, I'm going to go to jail because there's no way a Canadian can hold that. I want to see Von Helton's yellow card. That's what I want to see. See, that's signed too, right?
You know, it's all fun and games to get an envelope. If you don't have the laminated authentic certification, it doesn't count.
Because I'm still going with the story that he surfed that out of his mother's mailbox, possibly. Or someone that I know got it for him. But either way, he doesn't have a card. Folks.
No card, no membership. Them's the rules.
Yep. That's how we roll. So, I don't know. I haven't really been paying attention. No one's really complained yet that they can't hear us. So I'm going to assume everything's good to go, folks. We're going to try this fucking video player on this fucking thing. Let's see what we got. So, I mean, I've played this before, but it's been a while since we've done the Von Helton Theater. And I think I'm going to do a recap of the whole Kelly situation. I was talking with Katie before about doing that, so I'll try to touch base with her. And maybe we'll do one of those soon. But I like to always start, especially when it's been a while, with this particular one, because this is a little piece of internet history. This is Von Helton's first foray into, I guess, podcasting or whatever he does. This is his first ever YouTube video, I'm pretty sure. Let's check it out. So this should work. Everyone should hear it.
Greetings, Cobra Conservatives. This is Baron Von Helton, and since I can't come to you in D.C. or New York, I thought that I would bring you to me. Here's my newest addition, Smokey the Ninja Cat, who is just had what was left of a TV dinner, and I just thought I would give you a shout out.
So he's been feeding animals TV dinners since before, you know.
It's a well-established trend. This is all the way back to 2006.
This player is kind of derpy. I don't know if it's the player or just... Folks, the quality of both video and audio is going to vary extremely tonight if we're just picking out of the vault. Because, you know, the technology for you youngins wasn't, you know, quite as cutting-edge and available back in 2012 and 2010 and shit. So... looks like it's lagging like a bitch, but we'll carry on, folks.
And see how this thing works. I probably have the cheapest webcam on the face of the planet, but I got it working, amazingly enough, so we'll see how everything works out. Thanks, and have a pleasant day.
And that was the beginning, folks, of the man we know now as Von Helton. Though it did start before. You know, obviously there was a build-up. There was the Delphi forums and about.com and
Earth of a Legend.
But that is, folks, I mean, I don't, you know. Let's see what else. That was just a short one I like to warm up with. What do we got here that I've got loaded already? The one-man army rant. I think we've heard that before.
Uh-oh.
But this one, I think this is North Dakota.
North Dakota sounds like a solid winner.
We'll start with the one-man army. I think I've played this before, but whatever. Whatever.
Signed an NDA, right? The army doesn't pay enough. That's not why I left. I left because I couldn't go out to the field and do my job. My job is not being at on post cleaning billets. My job is being in my tank out on the field practicing and training. That was my job. Okay? My job was not cleaning billets. Okay, they got civilians that can do that shit. My job was to be in my tank, out there on the gunnery range, firing my main gun, firing my coaxial, firing the machine guns, you know, doing shit, you know, changing tracks, you know, going through mud puddles, whatever. Okay, my problem was that I was doing Susie Homemaker every fucking day, and I got tired of that shit. I wanted to go out in the field, and nobody wanted to go out in the field. Everybody wanted to stay home. Well, that's not my job. I went into the army to fucking train so that I could go out and do my job. See? That was why I left the army. That's why I opted to go into civilian duties. Because I couldn't go out to the field. Alright? It had nothing to do with a medical. It had nothing to do with dishonorable discharge. It had nothing to do with any of that shit. Now, I was getting a little bit of flack from a sergeant in my platoon or in my unit. Okay, I was getting a little bit of flack from him, but even that wasn't no big deal. Okay,
that's important to remember.
The thing that upset me was that when I went to the captain about it, they said it would take up to a year to get a fucking transfer. I ain't never heard of a transfer taking a year. Okay, but somehow for some strange reason, my transfer would take up to a year to go through. And they say, well, you can either wait a year to get a transfer, or you can go into civilian work. And I said, well, I'll go into civilian work. And so that's what I did. The Army provided my martial arts background. No. No, I was doing martial arts long before I went into the military. Where the fuck did you get that? You're an Army... You're an Army...
Now, I just want to make it clear for anybody who may be new, which I think everybody here already knows the lore of Von Helton. But, To be clear, his civilian work was going AWOL and doing dishes in a diner.
Until his mommy picked him up.
Yeah, until his mom come and give him a ride home. And he just never left, apparently. So
something tells me his job in the Army was to exit the Army as soon as possible.
Right, and ask not to come back.
Please. Well, at least not without a waiver.
Right, just we don't need you, sir.
You know, he also mentioned that he had a sergeant. It wasn't that big a deal. It's funny because... he tells the story later, and Sergeant Ward, he names him, Sergeant Ward, bullied him out of the service. And that's why he went to civilian work. Because if there's one thing we know about super soldiers is that bullying is their Achilles heel.
Mm-hmm.
Like, you know, they can wade through oceans of blood to kill their enemy. But when someone makes fun of them, they can't handle it.
No. And apparently, wasn't it two of them related? There was like a sergeant and a somebody else, and they had the same name, and he believes that they were working together, and he punched the one.
Something like that. I almost want to say both of their last names were Ward. Like, he was so lazy in making up the story, he didn't even give him a new name.
Right. No, 100%. All right, let's keep pushing on.
You're a tank driver? Really? I'm not... Ghost Man, this is not... I told you. I don't mind doing the stuff if it's okay. But we never went out to the field. We only went to the gunnery range one fucking time the whole time I was there. Once. Okay, that's insane. I'm supposed to be there to train to fight. I'm supposed to be there to do my job. Okay, I'm not complaining that there was, you know, the usual duties that you have to do around the billets. But the point is that that's all it was Susie Homemaker every fucking day. We never went out to the field. And when I went to the brass to find out why, they told me, and I said, well, you know, what's going on here? I could have transferred to another unit and got field duty. But they didn't want to transfer me for whatever reason. I don't know why. A year to get a transfer through? I've never heard of that in my life.
Well, I don't know. I know people in the military that could wait quite a while for a transfer. But I don't know. I think this whole, I don't know why they wouldn't transfer me. It reminds me of this time when I used to work in retail, right? And it used to be the trick, if it was missing a power cord, you just take it from another model and it just keeps going down the line. But eventually, right, you got to deal with the fucking extension cord missing. Right. So I think that he is the missing extension cord, right? And they're just like, you know what? We're at the end. All we're doing is passing the problem off to somebody else, sir.
Right.
Would you please just leave and not represent us? So anyways.
Certain things that I'm not allowed to talk about because I signed an NDA, right? The Army doesn't pay enough. That's not why I left. I left because I couldn't go out to the field and do my job. My job is not being at.
I guess this is just looping around at this point. It was a pretty short
video. I was going to say, it sounds like it just started over swiftly on us.
So, let's... it's kind of... I think it's playing a little derpy, though, to be honest with you.
It's hard, and, you know, the first video... It's no telling because the video has been copied a bajillion times and it's from 2007. But this one is on Vaughn, so I would put this at like 2012, 2013. So it's certainly not as old.
Mm-hmm.
It may be the player. It's hard to tell.
I got a lot of videos. Maybe that's because I have too many videos. My first time trying it, folks. So I'm
testing
its limits. That's what we're doing tonight. We're testing the limits. We may have too many videos.
Much like Von Hilton's belt loops, we are testing. The load capacity.
That's right. The tensile fucking. All right. So, this one, I don't know. I dumped a couple videos, so let's see if this works.
It's in Montana. It's North Dakota. And the child is, what we're doing. Okay. I went to court yesterday and we got some things taken care of. Obviously, next on the agenda is. We're going to pursue every possible attempt to get another DNA test done, this time by blood, so that she can't fake the damn thing. She has to go to a doctor.
So this is to do, so people don't get confused, this is actually to do with the child he denies in North Dakota.
His firstborn.
The first Jerry. Jerry number one.
The true blood heir. True blood heir.
Really? Yes.
Of that property.
Yep. Yeah. Folks. So, it's just interesting, you know, how Von Hilton repeats himself, much like history, right? But, you hear this, we're going to court, they're going to sue. This is when what happened was they came at him for support, they were raising the child support. And Von Hilton's like, well, fuck it then, I'm going to take the kid. And he threatened to take the child and shack him up in the room with little Jerry. So big Jerry and little Jerry would share a room.
Double Jerry's.
He's like, well, I'm paying for it. I'm gonna, I get the kid. So it was interesting. He thought that was actually like an argument. He was threatened to steal. Kid.
Oh, I gotta pay for him. Then guess what? He suffers with me.
Yeah, you had him half the time. I get him the other half.
I remember that.
Yeah, I think this might be the video, but it is playing pretty derpy. I do have a backup playlist. We can play it through another player. So. We'll get to that in a minute, folks.
Okay. Because you can't fake a blood test, all right? Because a doctor has to do it. So we're going to pursue that avenue. And then once the blood test proves that I'm not the father of the child, good old Katrina is going to fucking federal prison. That's going to be awesome. That's going to be awesome. Now, what happens to the kid? I don't know. It's not my kid. Don't care. Right? It's not my child. Never been my child. And once we get that blood test and it proves that it's not my child, she goes to federal prison for fraud.
I'm sorry, Wilson has just donated $2 through Super Chat. Jerry's all the way down.
Jerry's all the way down. Sorry, you don't hear it, Mike, but when I get Super Chats, I stop it just to let it play. Thank you very much.
Because she not only defrauded the state of North Dakota, she also defrauded the state of Kentucky. Bam, double whammy, all right? So she will be gone a long time, all right? That's why she's balking against getting another test done in the first place. Because she knows she fucked up. She's
going
to go to federal prison. No, Katrina is not my wife, damn it. Katrina is not my wife. Andrea is my wife. And Pamela was my first wife. But Katrina is not my wife and never has been. So, anyways. And after the blood test is done, and it is confirmed that the child is not mine, good old Katrina is going to be going to federal prison for a very long time. Defrauding not one, but two states. Oh, yeah, she's gone. She's out of here. Now, if on the just unbelievably crazy notion that the blood test should come back and the child is, in fact, mine, then in that case, we will be pursuing full custody. I mean, she's had the child for 15 years, wouldn't let me talk to him, wouldn't let me see him, not even so much as a fucking postcard, right? Okay, so now it's my turn. Now it's my turn. She had the child for 15 years, now it's my turn. I get the kid. Full custody, 100% custody. That is what we will be pursuing if she does not have her significant other adopt the child immediately.
Now, wait a minute.
That's ipso facto. That's Kentucky state law.
So, so Von Helton, the child that he just got done, you know, denying, right? Not my kid. Now is threatening to kidnap if the significant other of her current man doesn't stand up and adopt the child immediately.
Bitch, she better marry him, else I'm taking him.
Yeah, or he's going to keep up the kid. I don't...
He better adopt him, or I'm going to get him.
This is like fucking, I don't know, this is like fucking pirate court, you know, like paying people off with a kid. And I'll take the firstborn, three pigs, and a fucking bag full of shekels. I don't.
Right. 3 acres and a mule.
You get a blanket and a rifle and your firstborn.
That's right.
And I mean immediately, because my lawyer is already hard at work drafting the paperwork for full custody, all right? So if Katrina wants to keep the child, she will have to get the man that she's with to adopt the child. Because if she doesn't, he's coming with me, period. My rights have clearly been violated. The boy doesn't even probably know I exist, all right? So, yeah, I'm pursuing full custody, and I'll get it, too. Because she's denied me access to the child for 15 years. Okay, that's bullshit. My rights have been violated. All right. The times that I had sex with Katrina, I could not get her pregnant. I tried 3 times to get Katrina pregnant. All 3 times failed. And after that, I stopped. I said, okay, well, you know, that's the...
All right, so... Von Helton now admits that not once, but 3 times he mounted the beast that once haunted the hills known as Katrina. And so he admits he was trying to get her pregnant. Like, this is what right. blows my mind. Like, he is I can just see this in court. Well, did you ever have any? Well, we were trying to have a baby. How many times? At least 3 times.
And well, I like that. You're denying the child. Time, he just says, well, I guess it ain't going to work out, sweetie. Yeah. On down the road I go.
Yeah. Later. Then he gets a fucking call. Yeah, you got it's a boy.
Well, how did he know immediately, right? Like,
right, well, didn't take. Didn't take.
I can tell. When my seeds ain't swimming, I can tell.
Yeah. It's an old Kentucky, hill trick. Well, I guess this would be Ohio.
Yeah, it's hard to say. And I know this is what I'm about to say is not very scientific, but I have seen images of this kid. And if it's possible to be a, I mean, he looks exactly like Vaughn. Like, exactly.
Mm. Well, let's just hope he, folks.
Poor guy.
So we got another second or two of this.
Cards that I'm dealt, right? You know, tried to get him pregnant 3 times, couldn't do it. I'm done. You know, wished her the best all that.
Tried 3 times. I was mounting her. I was pumping her. I was trying it. But it didn't take.
Or Katrina.
Golly. All right.
You think that's her name, or he just, you know, that was the nearest natural disaster.
No, I have actually seen her docs years ago.
It's the status on my court case involving the child in Montana. Well, it isn't Montana. It's
Why are you not removing? There we go. Jesus Christ, folks. But I don't know. This player is pretty...
That one was the best of the three for sure, but it still was a bit
it was
choppy.
Freezing up and fucking. I don't know. I've been removing stuff. I do have it on a player. I just want to make sure that you can hear it. I know I can broadcast so everyone out there sees
right.
It. Well, let me try something here, and I'll move it to another screen. Folks, it's a one-man show. I know there's much better ways of doing this. I'm just cobbling my way through it. All right, let's... if I put it over here and then share it in there, everybody should be a winner. Give me 1 sec, folks. I'm just going to get rid of these videos.
Got me.
Yeah.
Oh, that's a... we got that one coming up.
That one sounded like a beauty. Revving up.
Oh, it was revving up. I'm going to kill her.
You better stop me.
Oh, my goodness. Yeah, let's do it this way. Folks, quality entertainment. This one. I think this might work, folks. What do we got here, Loda? That was North Dakota. Let's go. This is an interesting one. This one, I don't know. Let's go SOPA rant. Let's go back to the SOPA.
This is a good one. I remember this.
All right. So this is when Von Helton temporarily, much like Joe Biden, I wouldn't say accepted Obama, but was on his side briefly when he thought this new SOPA law was going to help him fight the trolls. And, yeah. Let's, hopefully it comes through.
Do you understand me, trolls and haters? It's going to pass. It's going to fucking pass. So now, if you're smart, you'll start removing your shit. If you're a dumbass, leave your shit up there and get your account removed by YouTube. Because I guarantee YouTube will comply. I guarantee they will.
I'm sorry, Wilson donated $5 through Super Chat. Thoughts and prayers in the chat for poor Katrina. She's the real victim. All she got was a bastard son, a yeast infection from Vaughn's pipe laying.
Oh my goodness. Thank you very much.
That's rough, Wilson. That's rough.
That is rough.
Will. I have no doubt in my mind that YouTube will comply with SOPA and PIPA. None whatsoever. Yeah, Walt needs an orange jumpsuit. It's what Walt needs. I can't wait to see that motherfucker in court. Walt from Delphi Forums. I can't wait to see that motherfucker in court. Me begging him, literally, to stop the people from destroying my forum on Delphi. And what does he do? He blocks me and lets them go in there and totally trash my forum on Delphi. Me begging him not to do it.
Shout out to
Walt.
So
yeah, I want to see that motherfucker in an orange jumpsuit. I want to see him standing in front of a judge to say, gee, Mr. Walt, you're the head of Delphi Forums, but yet you let these people harass Mr. Von Helden? Why did you do that? I can't wait to see his answer. I can't wait to see his fucking answer. Destroyed all kinds of zip files I had on my forum. I had all kinds of zip files of my own unique created content. Irreplaceable. One of a kind. And Walt just let a bunch of haters go into my forum and just destroy all the zip files, trash my whole fucking forum, and me powerless to stop them. All I could do was sit there and refresh the page and watch them do it. I couldn't do anything. My account had been disabled.
Single tier.
So yeah, I can't wait to see that motherfucker in an orange jumpsuit. That'll be fucking awesome. But if Delphi Forums doesn't comply, they're getting shut down. If YouTube doesn't comply, they get shut down. So I know YouTube's going to comply, because they don't want to get shut down. I know. They don't have no choice. YouTube doesn't have a choice. An Encyclopedia Dramatica? Holy fuck. Is there anybody in the room dumb enough to support Encyclopedia Dramatica, which is, by their own admission, a hate website? I mean, come on. Nobody, hopefully, is that fucking stupid. Encyclopedia Dramatica, by their own admission, is a hate website. Okay, by their own admission. Okay, so hopefully nobody's stupid enough to support Encyclopedia Dramatica. So yeah, that shit's gone. But I am just sick and tired of the infantile bullshit that's been going on of late. And I'm hoping SOPA and PIPA passes. I hope to God it passes. Because I'm tired of this shit. I'm gonna be almost 50 years old, man. I'm tired of this shit. And what is my horrible crime? Me trying to get on here and warn you about shit. Oh my God, that's so horrible.
I need G-Man. Someone get a hold of G-Man now.
DragonJim DGJ donated $4.99 through Super Chat. Funny how every place Vaughn has been, it's the same story, and they're all going to jail.
Every fucking one of them are going to jail. Thanks a lot, DragonJim. Folks, if you want to help me out with the Heine fund, you can hit the Liquor and Whores tab as well, just to let you know. I'm e-bagging for Heinekens. There it is.
Yoko Puffs is e-bagging for your money.
We got MeWe, we got Discord. Join us. Join us. Alright, anyways, let's get back to this. Yeah, it's funny, it's just like, you know, we all know, anybody that's followed Von Helden knows that he's a broken record, right? But it's just funny, just insert new names, right? Into his little
that's,
fantasy.
That's literally it, yeah.
It's wow, folks.
You know what we gotta
that's
do?
That's so
we gotta
horrible
find Walt.
That I would get on here and actually try to...
What's that?
You know what we gotta do, right? We gotta find Walt, get an interview.
That's right, we gotta get Walt.
That's our next step.
Walt, if you're out there, hit me up.
I gave up the opportunity to be wealthy. I gave it up. I was being groomed, man. I was being groomed to be a mayor or governor or some shit. I was in the Young Republicans. I was hobnobbing with congressmen and senators and foreign dignitaries. I was eating fucking caviar and sipping wine, dude. And I gave it up to hang out with you fucks. I should have had my fucking head examined.
I also want to point out that it just fucking strikes me like Von Helden says he's almost 50 years old, so Von Helden would probably only be a few years older than me when he's making this video, right?
Isn't that tragic? I mean, and look at this guy.
I know, and he looks like he's fucking...
Like the dirt on his hands today has been grandfathered in from this video, right?
Oh my goodness, fuck. The years have not been kind to poor Von Helden. That's what happens. The internet fucking sucks you dry, man. I've seen that happen to all the cows. They get internet hip and they get all fucking You know, you've seen it.
Oh, yeah.
I should have had
many
my
such cases.
Yes.
Head examined. Yeah, I'd be a puppet of the New World Order right now. But you know what? At least I'd be living a good life. I certainly wouldn't be having to worry about money right now. That's for damn sure. But I gave it all up so that I could get a bunch of fuckwads on YouTube to hate on me? Really? Boy, I need my fucking head examined. I need my fucking head examined.
All I had to do was drink that baby blood and I could have been Emperor of Kentucky.
They don't give a fuck, Septera Corps. All they care about is hating on people. And if it wasn't me, it'd probably be somebody else. Like I said, look what they done to July 4th Patriot. Look what they've done to Sacramaniac Doc. They did that shit before they got to me.
Real quick, July 4th Patriot, right. I'm pretty sure, is like a dastardly character.
Yeah, well, I was actually just going to bring that up. I don't want to be telling any tales outside of school, but I think he was caught up in some pretty fucking heinous shit, wasn't he?
Like super dark, like guns and like underage girls. Uh-huh. That's how I understand it. Now, of course, the Illuminati tricked him, right?
Right, right, right.
But they caught him, if I remember correctly, they caught him with weapons he didn't have, the, you know, like machine gun type weapons.
Right.
And they caught him being a little frisky with someone that was quite young.
Wait, I remember some shit going down. Anyways, that's enough of that, I guess. But just folks, just giving you context of the type of people that Von Helton surround himself and defend, right? But anyways, let's keep going.
And after I'm gone, they'll find somebody else to troll and hate on and destroy their lives. Look at all the young women that they convinced to commit suicide. Remy Jax, let me tell you something about the politicians. Politicians don't give a fuck about the internet. They don't. They don't give a fuck about the internet. If the internet was gone tomorrow, the politicians wouldn't shed one fucking tear. They hate the internet. Well, I don't know. Well, I don't know if they actually hate the internet, but they sure as fuck don't like it.
Has just donated $5 Australian through Super Chat. That's why Von is so conservative with his precious seed. You know he'd be dead if he just sprayed that seed around. Grin.
Did you hear that?
I did, yeah, I heard it, yeah.
Okay, well, there you go. Yeah, Vaughn is a seed
spreader. Seed spreader.
I just see him playing in the middle of a fucking dry Kentucky field. Just spinning around, spreading the seed.
Ladies?
Oh, goodness gracious. Ugh.
You know why they don't like the internet? Because you're getting all kinds of information on their ass, and they don't like that. They don't like it.
He's got the gas station's finest e-cig. Gas station select.
So yeah. Yeah, I support SOPA and PIPA 150%. Because finally, I'm going to get the support I need to shut all these fucking haters down. Now, granted...
Now, maybe I'm suffering deja vu, or maybe I'm just getting timelines mixed up, but didn't he leave all butthurt over these SOPA, and once he learned that it wasn't, then he came back and did the Hot Wheels, and then he left again when the new fucking whatever it was that came in?
You know, the SOPA and PIPA thing, I want to say was like 2013-ish, and of course, everyone on the internet was against it, and I don't want to tell any tales outside of school, but from what I remember, it was very unpopular amongst people that like the internet, you know?
Yeah, yeah.
I don't exactly remember what the fuss was about per se, But I know that Vaughn just got it in his head that you couldn't record. Just like now, when he's doing his little secret password streams and his stuff he's doing over there on D-Live, the rock and roll show. This is what he did in 2012 when he was so mad people were recording him right. and laughing at him. He was just like, well, I guess I'm not going to talk anymore.
Yeah, he'll just sit there and do rock and
same
roll.
Same thing. Yeah, same so, thing.
But I remember him leaving all butthurt because, of course, he left last time, coincidentally, folks, because he realized that, I don't know, he had it in his head that the last set of regulations were going after pedos. So for some strange right. reason, he bailed out of YouTube.
I thought that was really nervous.
Yeah. But that same kind of thing happened with this, too. It all backfired on him when he realized that it wasn't his dream come true of, you know, his free ticket to, you know, anyone hurting his feelings on the internet he could take to court. So, but I do remember, I think he retreated for a little while, all butt hurt.
I think you're right. He at least went into one of those little Vaughn cocoons where, you know, he was doing a friends only show on Blog TV or, you know, the rock and roll show where he refused to talk. You know, that's right. his big protest, you know?
Uh-huh. All right. Well, let's keep watching.
They'll still be able to make a YouTube video, but they'll have to show their real face. They won't be able to use a fake name. They'll have to use their real name, their real address, their real phone number. They'll have to show their face. See, now you say, well, that's not the SOPA part. No, it's not, but it is in the PIPA part. Did y'all know that in PIPA, you got to use your real name, your real face, your real address, your real height, your real weight? You can't fake anything anymore. That's in the PIPA part, guys. That's in the PIPA part. No more of these fucking avatars and shit. You have to show your face. You have to give your real name, your real address, your real phone number, your real height, your real weight. You can't lie about anything about you on the internet if PIPA passes. That's in the PIPA part now. That's not in the SOPA part. That's in the PIPA part.
Like he's read it. And I think, if I'm not mistaken, this was like hundreds of pages of like legalese. Were these bills? And he's acting like he read them.
Right. He's interpreted it. Can you just imagine, but Vaughn Helton of all people calling for truth and honesty about like your height and your weight.
Right. You got to have a retina scan, a thumbprint ID just to log into your Facebook.
That's right. Mr. Vaughn Helton, Mr. 5 foot fucking 11.
Mr. Freedom, you know, he's Mr. Freedom.
Yeah.
You know, you must sign in with Big, you must give a blood sample to sign in to Big Brother.
I think it's just hilarious that every time a fucking liberal caves and gives him something he thinks he's getting out of it, all of a sudden they're not so bad. Well, he'll never say that, but he'll just jump right on it. He's just, oh, I'll take that. I'll take those.
I mean,
Biden
if they're
bucks.
Real listen, if they're real communists, like lining people up against the wall, communists,
yeah,
those are okay.
Yeah, well, they're the real ones. They're gonna help fight.
Stalin types, you know, real hard men.
They're gonna help fight the fake ones.
That's right.
When he gets those his Vietnamese
all the purple hairs.
Yeah, long-haired, freaky people. Well, what do we got next after he's done here? He's got a couple, few words to say. Is this Billy Goat's not done baaing yet, I guess. So, well,
look at that dirt. He's got like a mask of dirt on. Or maybe it's just the shadow. I can't tell.
I think it's just the texture of his, like the moon, you know, and the fucking light hits it a certain way. He's got and landing sites.
It's like a cloud, right? We're all interpreting it.
Oh, dude, we should take a super close-up of Vaughn Helton. You know how those nutters on the moon pics, like, fill in the buildings and stuff?
Yes.
I'll do a video like that, but it's just a zoom-in of Vaughn's skin. Some unknown part of his body, and we'll find, like, little alien civilizations. Fucking...
Oh, that would be amazing. Look what we found on the moon. Oh, wait, that's your face, Vaughn. My fault.
The moon. All right.
Okay. You can no longer lie on the internet. Period.
Lying is
so
outlawed.
When SOPA and PIPA are signed into law, all these fucking haters on YouTube are going to have to start using their real name. Isn't that fucking awesome? Isn't that fucking awesome? Got my kids taken away. Secular opinion, shut your fucking mouth, you fat fuck. You don't live very far away from me. So I'd be keeping my mouth shut if I was you. You ain't across the pond. You're in my neck of the woods. You don't think I know about the pasta-eating boys up there by Niagara Falls? What if the pasta-eating boys owe me a favor? secular opinion? What if they owe me a favor for not doing a hit on their ass? And so to pay me back, they come and knock on your door. Do you know who I mean by the pasta-eating boys? Do you get what I'm saying to you? Do you? Do you understand secular opinion?
Do you understand this threat?
Oh, Vaughn, I didn't get your kids taken away. You liar. You liar. You fucked your eyeballs in this shit, just like all these other fuckwads. So don't say that shit. Don't say that shit. You know, maybe I ought to talk to some of the guys up there in an Italian restaurant up there at Niagara Falls. Is that what I need to do, secular opinion? Go up to Niagara Falls and go to a certain Italian restaurant and order me a stromboli and sit down and have a talk with some people? Is that what I need to do? Huh? Ha! Talk to me, you prick!
That's so good.
Oh, good times.
Yep.
So,
oh, no.
Oh, yeah. So I think you know where we're going with this.
Oh, no.
This was some Class A rage. We got some Yawn. We got the fucking Dueling Wolves. We got Lone Wolf and Spellbinder.
That's right. Both of them are very spiritual, as you can tell.
Yeah, yeah. Even got Raven in there. Jeepers, it's full house. I don't know. There's some good rage here, folks. So let's get into it.
Yep. Well, Lone Wolf, you and DZ are having a good chuckle at my expense.
You shut the fuck up. No, I don't even know the fucking guy. I don't even know the guy, Vaughn. I don't even know him.
Really? So all your comments on his page are just making...
Well, I didn't make no comments. I don't have no time to be bothering with your stupid fucking ass. Don't try to talk over me. It ain't gonna happen. I've been listening to your shit for two fucking weeks, three weeks now, that I'm a troll, that I'm out to get you, and I never did a fucking thing to you. Don't know your fucking wife. Never talk to your fucking wife.
Oh, you were never in a Google Hangout when my wife
no,
was...
No, I was never in a Google Hangout with your fucking wife. So don't give me this bullshit. Why don't you just admit that you fucked up and you treated her like shit and ignored her?
Get wrong.
Why don't you stop fucking blaming everybody else and stop blaming every fucking money else because of your fucking problem, and you can take your comments and shove them up your ass because it's called... I don't want to hear about my comments. I'm sick and tired of hearing your crazy ass shit that everybody's out to get you. I don't even fucking know. I got enough fucking things going on in my life. I don't need to worry about Andrea. I don't need to worry about Andrea. I got enough things going on in my life besides your fucking dingbat wife. You fucked up. You accused me of something that I did, and I didn't do shit. So you can go fuck yourself. I didn't. Oh, you're a fucking retard.
I never did.
Goddamn comments saying. Oh, big fucking deal. What are you gonna do to me? I didn't fucking do anything to you and your wife. I tried talking to you, and you fucking turned on mine, and you stabbed me in the back and said I was fucking goddamn saying I was doing this and doing that.
Is this spelling?
You
and long, long I found out that you and
you stabbed me in the back. You stabbed me in the back.
Motherfucker.
I went into a full fucking shit. Where's the proof? Where's the proof? Show me the proof, crazy man. Where's the proof? Show me the proof. No, they won't get out there because you ain't got shit. You ain't got dick. You ain't got dick. And you want to stab me in the fucking back. And yes, I love that picture.
We'll find out.
Bullshit. There is no find out, motherfucker. You stabbed me in the fucking back. You turned around and said, you are a lying whore because you turned around and called me and said I was in with Kenny KPZ and arrested him, and I wasn't doing shit. I was in with fucking guy named Alf. I was in with Alf and everybody else.
I got the name mixed up. Big fucking deal.
Yeah.
I got the name mixed up.
Oh shit.
But you and Dirty
Moon
were in collusion for the whole time.
Then arrest me. Throw me in jail, please.
I don't need.
Because you're a fucking lawyer.
Expose your lying ass.
Expose my ass.
All I need to do is expose you.
Expose
I don't need
shit.
You,
I never did a fucking thing to your fucking ass. I fucking said that because you're a fucking lunatic who likes sitting online telling your dirty laundry out in public. And we told you to shut the fuck up. And oh, look at him going bananas because he's fucking out here. Yeah, you are going bananas. Yeah, you are going bananas. You fucking pissed me off because you fucking turned around and you said, I back. No, don't give me your shit. You backstabbed my ass. You backstabbed my ass. You backstabbed my ass and you told me I was in with Dark Zodiac, and I wasn't in with Dark Zodiac. I never met the guy in the first place. I don't know any of these fucking people. And you know it.
Is Andrea. You have not hurt me. You have not hurt
me. No one's trying to hurt your dumb ass. You're hurting yourself, stupid.
You have not hurt me at all. All you've done is hurt Andrea.
Try again. Keep on muting me, asshole. Nobody hurt you. You hurt yourself. You hurt yourself because you were a big mouth and couldn't shut your face on the internet. If you would have shut your face on the internet, you would have shut up and nobody would have bothered with you. But no, you got to be out here being an attention whore. That you are. You are an attention whore. You are an attention whore. You like the attention.
The only people I see that
I got to have people. I have to have people paying attention to me all day because I'm an old man who lives out in the middle of nowhere, and I got to have people paying attention to me. Why don't you go get a job where you ain't on the internet all day worrying about what everybody's talking about? You ain't got a job.
Fucker. I got
your
a
mother's
business,
paying for your internet right now. Your mother's paying for your internet right now. And you got to live in her fucking house because you can't go out and be your bum. You're a loser. Fuck you. And you lost your wife. You couldn't even keep your wife in the house because you didn't pay attention to her. You sat on there fucking talking for 12 hours a day. No, you didn't pay attention to her. No, you didn't.
I tried to help you.
I did try to help his ass. I told you, Vaughn, get offline. Stop fucking talking online. But you can't. You had to, I got to talk to strangers.
Yeah,
that I don't fucking know. I gotta talk to strangers all day that I don't even fucking know. I gotta keep on going trying to mute me, asshole, because it ain't working. Go ahead. Go ahead, keep on trying to mute my ass, you asshole. Like I said, I got nothing to do with none of these motherfuckers out here, and you stabbed my ass in the back by telling me I was in with Dark Zodiac, and I wasn't in with Dark Zodiac. I don't even fucking know the guy from Sin. If I met him tomorrow, I wouldn't know him except for the pillow on his head.
Your comments are in his fucking video where he's...
Well, then show me the proof, you asshole. Show me the proof. Show me the proof.
He made the video.
You ain't got no proof.
He made the video private, but I screenshotted your comments.
Then show me the proof. Show me the proof, Vaughn. Pull it up, Vaughn. Please, show me up.
I this evening. I might as well pwn your ass, too.
Yeah. You ain't pwning nobody.
I show your comment. Are you going to try and get him to kick me out? You fucking pussy.
Why would I get him to kick you out?
Fuck your room being all nice with me, and at the same time, he's talking to ZZ behind my back.
Oh,
trying to get
fuck
my wife
you.
To leave.
I'm not talking to nobody behind your fucking back. I wasn't talking to nobody behind your fucking back. Nobody. And yes, Andrea should have left your ass because you were on internet all night and you weren't paying attention to her. She's a young woman.
I was on the internet for 4 hours.
Oh, fuck you, you were. You were for 12, 13 hours at a snap. Fuck you. Bullshit. I was in those chat rooms with you while she was hugging on you. She wanted your fucking attention, you asshole. She wanted your attention. Bullshit. She wanted your attention. Well, 8 hours is what you're spending with your wife. Not on talking strangers. Well, all bullshit because she had nothing else better to do. She had nothing else better to do. What was she going to do? She had a fucking. Oh, she wasn't. Show me the proof. Show everybody the proof she was cyber sexting. Show us all the proof.
I already submitted it to court, you dummy.
Oh, yeah. That's not proof. That's your word. That's only your word. That's your word. That's your word.
That's your word. No, it's not my word.
No, bullshit. No. Bullshit. Sorry. Then bring out the court documents and show us. Well, you can't because you're a lying sack of shit. You're a lying sack of shit.
No,
you're a lying
either.
Sack of
no,
shit.
Either,
you're a lying
you
sack of shit.
Court, you dumb
goodbye. You're a lying sack. It's done. She didn't admit anything for. Who the fuck was in there? You and her.
Stop talking. You're a moron. Stop talking.
Big fucking deal. You're lying through your fucking
I'm not
teeth.
Lying. You just can't admit that you damaged Andrea for life. You have ruined her for life, dude.
You ruined her for life. You ruined her because you're an old fucker.
I didn't tell her to leave.
Bullshit. Yes, you did tell her to fucking leave, you asshole. You told her to fucking leave.
Oh, Andrea, you need to go out and get this EPO right away, Andrea.
I'm a paranoid bastard because you threw her out of the house, you fuck. You threw her out of the house because you made out. Oh, fuck you. No one's told your wife to leave you. You threw her out, you asshole. You threw her out. I'm a loony asshole from Kentucky.
Here it comes, folks. The catfish. I like to call this maneuver the general. So we're at this point. We're at this fucking point of the argument where they're just making noises over each other, of course. But this is a redeeming frame coming up here, folks. The Kentucky catfish. I'm just going to put it back. Prepare yourself, folks. If you have any children.
Ladies, get ready.
Yeah, this is...
No one told your wife to leave you. You threw her out, you asshole. You threw her out. I'm a loony asshole from Kentucky. I'm crazy.
Stick your hand in an old log. What do they call
that? We call that the Harold Beauregard right there.
What do they call that catfishing with a fucking arm?
Oh, noodling.
Noodling. Go down for a Kentucky
noodling with the bone.
Pull your arm out up to the elbow. He's got a fucking... Got yourself a Von Helton.
Oh, damn, boy. That's a Helton of a fish.
Look at the whiskers. Carrying worms.
You can't do it. Yes, I can talk over you, asshole. Yes, I can talk over you, asshole. Want to try again? Yeah, I can. Go fuck your asshole because you are a loser. Loser. At least I have a girlfriend and she loves me and you can't even hold on to a 20-year-old girl. You can't even hold on to a 20-year-old girl, Vaughn. How depressing is that? 20-year-old girl. You can't even hold on to her because she, nobody's listening to her. She left because you're a miserable old man who sits in his little trailer all day, whining and complaining about how bad his life is, and sitting on the internet, bullshitting all day, just to total fucking strangers. Because you wrecked your own home, you piece of shit. You wrecked your own fucking home, you piece of shit.
Fuck you.
I don't fucking care. Because if they don't give a shit, if anybody trusts me ever, you're a lying motherfucker.
Hey, wait a minute. If I could just interject for a moment.
I'm going to interject. I got better things to do since listening to this old fucking crazy bastard on here backstabbing everybody, talking how he's going to throw everybody in jail. Well, I'm going to throw you in jail. You ain't throwing shit in jail. You don't have a fucking law degree. You don't know nothing about the fucking law. No, fuck you. You don't know dick about the law. And you fucking put that girl through all that bullshit, and she deserved to fucking leave because you're a fucking crusted old ass, written old bastard who sits on the internet talking to bullshit to strangers all day, who couldn't get off the fucking net for 5 minutes to fucking be with your wife for Easter, be with your wife for Valentine's Day. No, you couldn't do that. No, of course you couldn't. You had to fucking sit there all day on the internet for 8-9 hours a day. So you're pathetic. I had enough. I got my piece out. You're a fucking lunatic, and everybody knows it. Later. Sorry, Spellbinder. I didn't mean to do this to you, buddy. I still love you.
He left like a coward. I think James was about to unleash the portalocalypse on him.
Well, here's the thing. I'm looking for his comments because I've got his comments saved. Where him and Dark Zodiac were just laughing and cutting up about how they got Andrea to file that EPO
right.
Against me.
Could you do me a favor, James, and get
no,
really
I can't.
Your
no, I can't. No, no, I'm sorry. I don't. No, I'm sorry. Excuse me. No, I don't do trolls any favors. Sorry.
Okay,
I don't do trolls
well,
any favors.
I'm not a troll, so it works out great.
I'm not a troll. Yeah, listen to that.
Really
yeah, I love that was funny. I got a good chuckle.
I'm laughing here.
I got a good chuckle out of that one. That was funny. Even Spellbinder thought that was funny.
Yeah, I got a chuckle really out of that. Funny guy. Thanks for the laughs, dude. I thought that was fun.
Glad I could help.
That was a good one.
Well, if you could just move your mouth really, really close to the camera again, I would really appreciate it.
No, I'm not going to do that. Fuck you. Let's see. I am looking for his comments.
I didn't say fuck you to you. Come on.
I know. I got you on the punch with that one. Oh, well, I beat you to the punch. So what? Where is Wolfie's comments? Let's see. I got Lodian's comments. Oh, those are real nice. Real nice comments. I gave a copy of Lodian's comments to my attorney, by the way.
But Lodian is not local. Just,
and he's all 13.
Doesn't matter. He was still talking disparagingly.
Well, I gave all of my comments to my attorney a couple of years ago, and he laughed at me out of his office.
There you go.
Uh-huh. Well, that's nice. That's nice. Let's see. Where are we at here? Sam Zodiac. It's Sam Zodiac.
These eyes. Dun, 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 dun. These eyes. Look at those fucking things, man. Old Blue Eyes Helton.
One cross blue, one way, and one. Turning his head.
Looks like one of those fucking rubber sharks, and you squeeze it.
Yeah, with the little, what do you call them? The stress balls?
Yeah.
And, you know, just for a little fill-in here for people that may not know, that Lone Wolf guy, he was quite the character himself. Mm. If anyone had a back on their ass, it'd be this guy. He seemed like he had a fetish for soggy mattresses and dirty ashtrays.
Right.
So, and he had exactly as many teeth as Vaughn.
Right. Right. Corn cob eating champions.
Where are we at? Okay, yeah. Let's skip down through the bullshit here because there's some miscellaneous. Well, never mind. I'll just read it verbatim. Sam Zodiac, you sound upset, Dwayne Alonzo Mountain Dew Herbert Camacho. You sound upset. What are you, a Vaughn fan? I'm done with the Vaughn Helton BS. A lot of controversy came from that very subject. Fallouts, friends turning on one another, etc.
So there's a troll account I haven't heard a name of.
I love how he says the whole thing, right? Yeah. Like, he says it all.
Oh, my goodness. Good times.
Now I'm ready to sit back and watch the show because it's going to get good. My only mistake was deciphering the audio. Oh, well, we all make mistakes and we learn from them. If anything, now here's the good part. If anything, it got Vaughn to trust me so that I could ask the questions I needed to ask. Hate me if you want, but not a single fuck was given when I advised Mouse to file domestic on Vaughn right after she left Vaughn before I ever went into Vaughn's hangout. At least she has gained some smarts and is going to make for a lousier show in the future. Have a nice day.
But that's okay. Not Lone Wolf.
But you're not, okay, listen.
That's
Lone Wolf. Excuse me.
It's not Lone Wolf. It's
Lone Wolf. I don't care. Shut up. Let me talk. I'm not changing the subject. You won't shut the fuck up.
Let Vaughn talk. Let him talk.
But you didn't find Lone Wolf's comments. That's what you said you were going to do.
No.
Shut up. Let Vaughn talk.
Let Vaughn finish.
He's not going to let me finish. Never mind. Fuck it. I'm going to
finish. Go ahead.
He's not going to let me talk. Spellbinder, he's not going to do it. He's not going to let me talk. So I'm done with it. But anyway, I've proven conclusively. There he goes again. Talking over me. I've already proven that Dark Zodiac was the one that told you. Dark Zodiac admitted to contacting Andrea to file the EPO. I've got proof that Lone Wolf was hanging with Dark Zodiac long before he called. Shut up! God damn you! Can't you shut the fuck up?
I can't hear you.
Can't you shut the fuck up?
This is why you're left.
No, let Vaughn talk. Come on, let him talk.
No. Either kick him out or I'm gone because I can't fucking talk over his ass. I was able to talk over Wolf, but I can't talk over him for some reason. Okay? So either kick him out or I'm done. It don't matter.
Everyone, let Vaughn talk. Okay? Okay. Everything's normal. Let Vaughn talk.
Right. Spellbinder.
I have screenshotted communications between Lone Wolf and Dark Zodiac before Zodiac contacted Andrea to file the EPO. That's what I've been trying to get out for the last fucking half hour. That everybody kept talking over me. I just got to find it. It's on my hard drive. I just got to find it. But I have it saved between Lone Wolf and Dark Zodiac laughing and cutting up how they're going to get Andrea to leave my happy ass and to file an EPO against me. Lone Wolf is a fucking traitor. He's a fucking homewrecker right along with DZ. They ruined my marriage. They did it intentionally and willfully and with malice and with intent. It was pre-planned. It was pre-orchestrated. Use whatever fucking adjectives you want. But it was all by design, in advance, planned out. There, now I'm done. Now you all can say whatever the fuck you want.
Where's the proof? Read the proof.
The proof?
Are you going to keep on pulling up my name, motherfucker?
No,
are you
going to keep on pulling up my name? No, I'm quite done. Have at it, dude. Go ahead. Yeah. Come at
you
me.
You
want to
keep on pulling up my name?
Come at me, bro. Come at me.
Oh, I don't want to come at
you. I've already outed your ass, man.
I don't beat up on elderly people. Nobody outed your fucking ass. Oh, fuck you. You ain't outed shit. All you got is a bunch of fucking wind up your ass. Yeah. Oh, you're talking to Dark Zodiac. You're talking to this one. You're talking to that one. Prove it, motherfucker. Prove
it. Where's Dark Zodiac? Where's he at when he can defend himself?
Well, I don't have to. He never did a fucking thing. Neither did I. This guy's making it up in his fucking goddamn head.
I just got to reading Zodiac's own fucking message where he did get back to it.
Because she had a right to leave your ass because you were a shitty ass fucking dumb bill hillbilly husband. She had every right to fucking leave your ass. Because you ignored her, holidays came and went, you ignored her, you did this with her, you did that with her. No one fucking got you. You never fucking paid attention to the kids. You never did anything. You lived in that goddamn pigsty. You never cleaned. Now you're cleaning it up. Yeah, because you're worried you're going to lose the kids. You're going to lose them anyway. You're going to lose them anyway.
Excuse me, I'm not losing Jack.
Bullshit you ain't. Bullshit you ain't. Bullshit you ain't. Hey, Sherlock, get the fuck out of here, you goddamn pedophilia. Go fucking play with yourself. Get out of here before I call the FBI on you.
Attention over here, motherfucker.
Yeah, fuck you, Vaughn. Fuck you, Vaughn. You're a backstabbing lunatic. You're fucking nuts. You're fucking nuts. No, you're the backstabber. About me, telling me that I'm fucking gonna, I'm doing this to you, I'm doing that to you, I'm doing this to you. It's all in your fucking goddamn head. It's all in your goddamn fucking head. Yeah, it's all in your, show me the proof, asshole. Show me the proof. Show me the proof. No, I don't want to hear you read it. I want you to post it in the room. I want you to tell. Yeah, please, post it in the room. And I guarantee it was me telling Andrea she should leave your ass because you're a fucking deadbeat for a husband.
Okay, so, well, what's the difference? You just fucking admitted it, you fucking idiot.
You're right. You should leave.
You just admitted.
You're right. You're a deadbeat. You're a deadbeat. Right. You're right. I admit it. You're a fucking deadbeat. You're right. You're a deadbeat.
You know why you admitted because, to it just now? Because you're going to fucking post this shit.
That's right. Because you're a deadbeat asshole. What am I looking at? Where am I looking at? What am I looking at? I don't see me.
I'm looking at DZ's own words.
So what?
Own fucking words.
That's not my words. That's my. I'm sitting right here. That's not my words. I don't see anything about me. I don't see anything about me. What do I see about me? Nothing. So you made the whole fucking thing up blaming me. Where does it say Lone Wolf? Where does it say Lone Wolf? Anywhere in there, Vaughn? Come on, Vaughn.
I didn't say I was going to post your shit. I said I was posting these.
No, please. Post my shit because you blamed me or something. You said I did it, and I did nothing. I backed away from you because you were going nuts and you were losing your fucking mind. Oh, shut the fuck up, you goddamn pedophilia. Before someone comes over to your house, you fucking pedo. If I fucking got on my hands on you, I'd break your fucking neck, you goddamn little dirtbag Sherlock.
Not a home wrecker.
Oh, you're the fucking home wrecker. You wrecked your own home, motherfucker. You wrecked your own home, motherfucker.
At least he's not a home wrecker.
Isn't that great?
I remember that character, who that was, too. That,
oh, anyways. Pour one out for President Camacho. Gone but not forgotten.
Oh, that one. Yeah. But, yeah, so, folks, there you are. A pedo is better than a home wrecker.
But he was so fucking mad.
Oh, he's big mad. Big mad. Let's take a little breather here for a sec. I'm going to check, because I haven't been able to see the comments, what's going on over here. Folks, how you doing out there? Got 156 people watching. Thank you for joining. And we got 88 likes. Not bad. Let's see if we can get it to 100, folks. That is our it's Pledge Week over on Von Helton's D-Live, by the way. I don't know if anybody knew that.
Pledge Week, a.k.a. every week.
Yeah. He has no lemons.
Lemonless.
He's lemonless over there, folks. Fuck, life's not even giving them lemons.
It's really not. He can't even catch a lemon.
The fucking Jesus Christ. My goodness. Folks, thank you for joining this evening. We have more on the burner here. Some classics. Johan's having a hard time getting a word in edgewise.
You know, he always did have that problem for some reason. And for whatever reason, the minute he spoke, Vaughn would fly into a heated rage for nothing. You know, like that whole time, I'm pretty sure that was the extent of the time they were all in that stream up to that point. So it wasn't like you took a clip of, you know, a larger stream. That was the beginning of it, from what I remember. And poor Johan really didn't say much at all. And he could never really get his foot in the door with old Vaughn.
Yeah, Vaughn, he was having none of it. None of it.
He was having none of it.
Oh, my goodness. Folks. All right, well, let's keep pushing through it here.
The fucker, because you couldn't even keep a 20-year-old girl satisfied.
I just met you admitting that you talked to Andrea, you fucker.
I didn't talk to nobody. I told Dark Zodiac and everybody, she should leave your ass because you are a dirtbag. You are a...
I know they were talking previous about something else, and I'm probably taking it out of context. I thought it was just funny when, you know, he brings up, you couldn't even keep your 20-year-old girl satisfied. He's like, see, you admitted you talked to Andrea.
Right.
You did talk to her.
Dumbag, dirtbag, who thinks of your fucking self.
No, actually, that's
and
not.
And we, hey, he's following. When he kicks Sherlock out, he's a goddamn pedophile. Kick him out of the goddamn room.
Prove it, motherfucker.
I don't have to prove it, you pedo. Yeah, thank you very much. Mute that fucking pedophiliac. He's Von Helton's one of his butt boys.
No, he ain't.
No, yeah, he is. He's a pedophile, just like you.
I'm not a pedo. Oh, we're going to... Oh, that's good. Yeah, that sounds good. My attorney will like to hear that
one. Oh, get your fucking attorney. I'm here in Pennsylvania, motherfucker. Come and get me. Give me a fucking break for talking on the internet. Unplug your computer, you fucking asshole. If you got a fucking problem, unplug your computer. You got a problem. You're the one putting your shit out here. Oh, come on. Give me. I'm going to do 1,000 years, right, Vaughn? I'm going to do 1,000 years, right, Vaughn? I'm going to do 1,000 years, right? Just like because your extensive law degree you have in your brain. I'm just going to nail us all. You're going to get me. You're going to get Dark Zodiac. You're going to get everybody. You're going to throw us all in jail. We're just going to call you from now on Sheriff Vaughn Helton. That's what I'm doing. Because you know the law. You don't know dick. You don't know dick about the law. Oh, here comes the pedo again. You don't know the law.
I don't have to
fucking prove it. You're a faggot. And you're a fucking pedophile, and it has been proven already. You got little girls and little boys on your fucking internet, fucking on your computer, and it's been found out. So go away, Sherlock. Go away. You fucking little pedo. Because if I got my hands on you, I'd break your fucking neck. You fucking little pedo. You ain't breaking shit, you little pedo. And tell your buddy Von Helton over there, your buddy over there. You know what? Yeah. I don't want to talk to pedos, okay? Thank you so much. I appreciate that. Get rid of the fucking pedo. Goddamn convicted pedophile.
Thank you. I did that out of your...
Yeah, well, make sure you block his ass because he's a fucking convicted pedophile and they'll start thinking you're a pedophile if you have him in your room. The guy's got 600 to 700 fucking pictures of little boys and little girls on his computer and they got tapped in. Yes, really, and it got tapped into because he's one of Bond's little buddies. because they don't do no wrong in their life. They don't do shit in their lives that are wrong. It's always everybody else's
fault. Oh, wow, look who we have. Andrea's friends list.
Oh, friends list. What's this?
It's all the friends list. Oh, I'm going to cry. I'm going to cry. I'm going to cry. I'm going to cry. Yeah, there's my name right there. That's my name, Len Bork.
Lone Wolf, right there. Lone Wolf, buddy, right there. Lone Wolf, right fucking there.
Keep on muting me, you cocksucker.
In a fucking friends list.
Dark Zodiac. Don't pick on Lone Wolf.
Oh, fuck off. I'll be
friends. Friends with anybody. We weren't talking to Bond's wife.
And if you know...
We weren't talking to Bond's wife.
Nobody was talking.
No, we weren't talking to Bond's wife behind his back. No, we weren't talking to Bond's wife behind his back.
You got no proof. You got no proof. You got no proof.
My friend. You're talking to my wife behind my back. You fucking traitorous bastard. You fucking homewrecker. Sitting there destroying my fucking marriage.
You got no proof.
You got no proof. You fucking die.
You got no proof. You got no proof. You
got no proof. You got no proof.
You got no proof. You got no proof.
Right there.
You got no proof. You got no proof. You
got no proof.
No proof. I can go on this all night long.
Proof too.
No proof. You got no proof. You
got no proof.
Yeah, I got proof that you shit in your underwear. Yeah, I got proof that you shit in your underwear. Yeah, I got proof that you shit in your underwear.
AKA Dark Wolf,
I can't even speak because I'm so lost.
And they're laughing and cutting up with Dark Zodiac.
That's on your...
I'd like to leave my ass and file an EPO against me.
That's
exactly what he did. That's exactly what he fucking 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 did.
Show me the proof.
That's exactly what he fucking did. That's exactly...
Proof. I'm not gonna sit here all night spellbinder listening to this fucking airhead from Kentucky out in the backwoods screwing up. Bye, Vaughn. I love you, spellbinder.
Yeah.
Got it right on the screen, you lying bitch. You fucking homewrecker. You fucking homewrecker.
Vaughn, chill out.
Come on. Yeah, we're all calm down here.
Wait a minute, guys. Stay put, everybody. Just let's take a breath. Let's all calm down. Just take a breath. Spellbinder, please, take a breath.
Yay, somebody finally unblocked me.
Let's just all calm down here, okay? Okay, right.
Now, what I think is funny is that y'all just sit there and fucking don't even say a word to this motherfucker, knowing that him and Dark Zodiac were talking to my wife and telling her to leave my ass. And y'all just sit there on your fucking ass and don't open up your goddamn mouth to say something? What the fuck's the matter with you? What if it was your wife? Hey, shut up! What if it was your
don't need to shut up,
what if it was your wife or your girlfriend, motherfucker?
Listen here, you fucking shit motherfucker!
Shut the fuck up!
Uh-oh.
Well, that was quite... There was, of course, more to that, I believe. I don't know what this next one is. He's got the fucking... If we could place it by the sweater.
You know, that looks like a Nadia hangout.
Yeah, it does.
I believe that's her right there next to Vaughn.
Yeah, it is. Well, let's see what it is, folks.
On the statue...
Vaughn?
Yeah, go ahead.
Yeah, Vaughn, I had a look at a video, and there's someone called Von Helton Jr.
Oh, God.
Review saying that you're going to take him to court. What's that all about?
He's trying to be my son.
There's no way in hell that guy is his son.
No fucking way in hell. No. I was in Texas. His mom claimed... He claims his mom was in Kentucky, so no.
He looks like he's eating cat food. Look at him.
Right. Had him on a little D-Dog.
Well, kind of is. He feeds it
and
to
then
the cat.
Right. He had this video of Vaughn, which would have been at that time when the kid would have been about still with him because he claimed that Von Leppen.
Oh, we got a detective in the room. Mm-hmm. Spoiling everything.
Where's the woman and where's the child?
Right. Exactly. Exactly.
So he shot on his own evidence.
Yeah, he shot down his own. He shot down his own. Logic and reasoning.
What if he's from a world where you are his father?
I'll shoot my fucking self, alright?
Or at least...
I knew that was coming.
But no, this is not... No, this... Trust me, this does not have anything to do with Mandela Effect at all. This is just some troll wanting to get his 15 minutes of fame. Well, he's going to get it alright. Because he's going to stand in front of Judge Clark down here. And he's going to say...
Judge
and
Clark.
Judge Clark's going to say, alright, you're slandering this man. You're accusing this man of a criminal act, which is abandonment of a child. Mm-hmm. You're going to go to jail. Do not pass go. Do not collect $200. You know, now he thinks he ain't going to jail. Well, I'm sorry, but he is, because he's accusing me of a crime. Right? Abandonment is a crime, and Judge Clark down here don't play with that shit. He don't play around. Right?
Judge
so
Clark
yeah, he's
don't
going
play.
To jail. Mm-hmm. He may not know it. He may not like to believe it, but.
I wonder what Bond's
you know,
opinion
don't,
of Judge Clark
you
is
don't
today.
Didn't
he say he was going to show up at your trailer or something?
Yeah, that would not be a good idea. That would not be a good idea. Not at all.
And he can't claim to be the kid that Von pays child support for because that ain't even the same age either. That's still under 18.
No, the kid that I'm paying child support on is only like 15, 16, something like
yes.
that.
And that guy... That age.
Yeah, so no matter which way he tries to spin this, he can't win. Because I've got civilian entities, let's call it, and I've got the US military who can vouch for the fact that I was in Texas, okay? You know, this isn't pie in the sky. You know, I've got military personnel that can say yes, he was in Texas during those years. And I've got civilian folks that can say yes, he was in Texas during those years.
At the diner.
So I mean, you know, this guy ain't got shit. He ain't got nothing to stand on. He ain't got a thing to stand on.
So what if he, you know, does decide to show up at your trailer? What exactly do you think is going to happen? Do you think he'll be arrested, or do you think he'll talk to him?
My mother will do him just like she did Andrea. She'll have him arrested. Absolutely. He's trespassing. He'll be arrested. Either that or he'll be shot.
Shot.
It don't matter to me which. Hey, I am well within my right to defend my home.
Depends
you know?
On his hostility level, dude. Whichever comes no. first.
You can't just shoot people walking up to your house, Von. I don't know if you know this or not.
Yeah, especially when you know what their intention's not violent.
Right.
Well, the guy was claiming to be my son, so I shot him. Problem solved. Can't be spreading rumors around like that. He's a hater. I can just see him making this case, right? Oh, my God. Von
his
Logic.
Mommy's going to handle it for him.
Oh, God. I don't even know what I got next.
I don't know if he's pounding on my door, acting like he's going to knock my door in. I wouldn't want to be him. That's
knocking on
say.
The door, folks. Knocking on
that's
the
a
door.
Crime in Kentucky.
I can tell you right now.
Oh, look at this
criminals
handsome fella.
In the jails that I know about, they don't take too kindly to people fucking with somebody's kids. Just... throwing that shit out there, guys.
Same closet.
Especially you, Ernie. Because you Uh-oh. Always seem to have a fucking smirk on your goddamn face. And I can't wait to see some inmate knock it off your face.
Well, how would you
I
see it,
I can't wait
right.
to see somebody knock that fucking smirk off your face.
Look at him. He's just so mad.
But we're going to have us some fun. Anyway. Yeah, we are. We're going to have us some fun.
Uh-oh.
This is a newer one. Oh, this is where Von a few months back called me out for being a pedo, apparently.
Wait, what?
Oh, did you miss that?
I must have. Yeah, this is news.
Well, yeah, so Von, this is his logic, right? Because it got brought up again, the infamous Welcome to the Humble Commode VHS tapes that I acquired.
That old
right?
chestnut, yeah.
And he still claims to this day that he was 17, and even though I proved he was like 27 or whatever, right?
Right. 24, I think. Something in that. So,
yeah, somewhere like that. I was 87. Yeah, he was 24. So he still claims he's 17. And then him and J-Dubs with a combined, you know, brain power, right? that they put together. They came up with this. Well, technically, if I'm in possession of a video of Von Helton when he's 17, well, that's I'm a pedo.
Oh, well, I mean, naturally.
So that was the logic. What? Yeah.
J-Dubs and Von, their brains combined together, working at the speed of smell.
Right, exactly. But, so yeah, that was interesting. So I think that's what this is. I'll just start it here anywhere, folks. Actually, I'm just going to take a little break, a little breather. I want to see what's going on in the comment section. I haven't been able to take a look. Who do we got out there? Romper Stomper, Domper Doo here. Anything illicit going on out here? Any fucking fights?
That looks like everyone's behaving themselves.
Yeah, it's pretty good. It's pretty good out there. Pretty good out there. Thanks for joining, folks. If you can hit the thumbs up, you know the drill. All that kind of stuff. Thanks for coming out. All right, let's hear Vaughn make random accusations.
Isn't that right, Secular? Secular Opinion, YouTube actually shut Secular Opinion down, and he whined and cried like a little two-year-old until YouTube gave him his channel back. Didn't you, Secular? Fuck yeah, you did, bitch, because I got that on video.
What?
Yeah, he's got everything on drives somewhere.
Does he have a hidden camera in your place? He's like, I saw you.
I cried right to YouTube. That mean Von Helton took my channel down. I think he still
butthurt
years ago because he hit me with copyright strikes and I won them. And I made that video winning. And he fucking,
I remember that.
He got so fucking butthurt. He's still hurt over it.
I got that shit on video.
Hmm.
Don't tell me.
He's got it on video.
So they're trying to project onto me what they really are. Okay. And that's exactly the truth. And so, yeah, it's fucking hilariously funny.
The closet is still open.
You know, maybe people need
back
to find out why in the fuck this son of a bitch
still
has
got
a video of me when I was a minor.
Yeah.
What about that, Secular? Why do you have a video of me when I was a little kid?
Because
remember, I'm only 17. I'm a minor.
No.
I'm a minor, motherfucker. What's the pedophile laws in Canada like, I wonder?
Well, first of all, just because you happen to have like some film footage and someone in it was 17 doesn't make it fucking illicit fucking material.
Look, buddy, as weird as it may be, if someone sent you a video of Vaughn in a diaper running around, that's still not anything illegal. What are you talking about?
And then, of course, add to the fact he's actually 24, folks.
Right. He was literally old enough to drink plus 3.
Yeah, so this is complete nonsense. But let's listen.
Let's see. Let's Google. Let me take my own advice, and I'm going to Google that shit.
Oh, here we go.
Pedophile laws in Canada.
That's right, Vaughn. Just keep typing that word into your Google searches.
As many times as you could. It'd be great.
Pedophile laws in Canada. Let's find out, boys and girls. Let's find out.
I wonder what the laws on digital horse pussies
are. Oh, there's a bill. Bill 145 out of Parliament. Protection Against Pedophiles Act, 1997. Oh, well, let's pull that up, boys and girls. Shall we? Fuck yeah, we are.
I find this very interesting because Von Helton just recently seems to be under the impression that we are all on an honor system as far as laws go up here and rights and liberties.
on an honor system.
It's all just, you know, based on precedent from, you know, the Westminster system. So we don't actually have any rights or laws or anything written down, or we just kind of, anyways. Jesus.
All right. Let us share our screen here, boys and girls. Oh, fuck yeah, we are. Bill 145, Protection Against Pedophiles Act. Outstanding, 1997. All right, explanatory note. The bill prohibits persons from retaining or continuing to retain the services of a pedophile in a position that involves dealing directly with children on a regular basis. The bill also prohibits pedophiles from acting in a position of that type 6 months after the bill comes into force. A pedophile is defined as a person who has been convicted of sexual crimes involving children or in respect of whom a prohibition has been made to.
So basically, I don't fit any of that criteria.
I mean,
I just want to make absolutely clear.
Right.
this proves nothing. I like how he's reading it like he's making a fact. Take that.
Yeah, right. This is like, hey, if you've ever been convicted of anything involving pedophilia, you can't run a daycare.
Right, exactly.
Keep that person away from children. The bill creates offenses for persons who contravene the prohibitions. However, an employer who has employed a pedophile is not guilty of an offense if the employer has obtained a letter from the police stating that the employee is not a pedophile.
So now we got to get you a letter from the police.
Preamble. Right. It is important to protect society in general and children in particular from pedophiles. To achieve that objective, it is desirable to prevent pedophiles from working in positions that involve dealing directly with children on a regular basis. The Legislative Assembly considers that the provisions of this act are justifiable in a free and democratic society. Therefore, Her Majesty, by and with the advice and consent of the Legislative Assembly of the Province of Ontario, enacts as follows. Definitions. Number one, in this act, pedophile means a person who has at any time been convicted of a sexual offense respecting a child or in respect of whom an order of prohibition has been made under Section 161 of the Criminal Code of Canada. Okay, so we need to Google Criminal Code of Canada.
This is just too much reading for Vaughn. He's going to get bored soon.
Let me grab a hold of it here. And we will Google that shit. Criminal Code. All right, let's bring it up, boys and girls.
I do appreciate that he reads this with conviction, like he's actually making a point.
Yeah, none of this is applicable in any way.
Scroll.
Yeah, I don't see we're hurting Von Helton's feelings on the internet.
That's the definition of a pedo. You hurt my feelings?
You see that?
Pedophile for life.
Okay. Wow. Holy shit.
Yeah, imagine that.
Okay, it's only a list. All they gave me was a list. Damn, this thing's huge.
Well, yeah, then you click
each. Okay, short title, we don't need that. Part one.
He's going to sit here and read the whole criminal code. Like, what?
Let's see, okay.
Starting at one.
Unless
haters.
Otherwise provided or ordered, anything done by a court, justice, or judge is effective from the moment it's done, whether or not it's reduced to writing. Two, unless otherwise provided or ordered, if anything's done by the bench of a court, justice, or judge, and it is reduced to writing, the clerk of the court may sign the writing.
Like none of this has to do with anything.
Okay, this is basically postcard of chattel value for the purposes of this act. A postcard or stamp referred to in paragraph of the definition of property in section 2 should be deemed as chattel.
He is actually reading about fucking postcards and like.
Right. This legal beagle, Von Helton. Fuck. Went from pedos to postcards in one move.
So there you are, secular.
To be equal in value to the amount of postage rate duty or expressed on the face. Okay, for the purposes of the act, following rule apply. Purpose determining the value of property, a value of security, where value is material, where the valuable security is one mentioned in paragraph A or B. Okay, we're talking a lot of stupid talk here. Let's get to the good shit.
Juicy stuff.
All this stupid talk,
about,
yeah.
We're talking about
I want this juicy here. Kitty fucking shit.
Let me find the real stuff here. Okay.
Look,
okay,
I was promised there would be some pedophile material in here.
Okay. All right. We got to find the prohibited acts. Okay. There we go.
Horse pussy.
Assisting alien and enemy to leave Canada or omitting to prevent treason. Everyone commits an offense who incites or willfully assists a subject of a state that is at war with Canada or a state against whose forces Canadian forces
smuggler Russians
whether or not a state of war exists between Canada and the state.
I love that
whose
we've gone
they
to
are.
Prove he was going to pwn you.
Canada
now we're just reading what
Crown
basic
list.
Laws, how they work in Canada.
Yeah, so just so we're on the record here, folks, I cannot smuggle out any enemies in wartime. If we are at war right. with a nation, I can't help the enemy smuggle
If there's
out.
Any hiding Russians, you can't sneak them across the border.
That's right.
The accused established assistance. Okay, well, I mean, that's about a time of war. Fuck. When do we get to the juicy shit? Everyone who commits an offense is guilty of indictable. Well, yeah, it's called treason. Duh. Anyone who does an act of violence to
I love that he's arguing with
Duh.
Text. Right?
Of course. Like, why do you have to write that down? Duh, everyone knows that.
Intimidate the parliament or the legislature. Every person is guilty. Okay, this is not helping me at all. This is just giving me the whole goddamn law.
Yeah, it's the criminal code. That's what you fucking look at. He's literally thinking it's like paragraphs. I'm pretty sure that if he went back, you know, it probably like told what section of the criminal code specifically, but he wasn't reading. It was just mumble jumbo anyways. He doesn't even understand what he's, you know. I'm actually impressed he's went this deep into it. I would have figured he'd lie.
You know, this is a look inside the research mind of Von Helton.
Getting the news to you first, folks.
He went from pedos to postcards.
Yeah.
With one move.
Yeah. And smuggling out enemies of the state if we were at
That's
war.
Treason, duh.
Duh.
Circuit. I mean, fuck. I don't need all that.
That's a hanging.
I just want the part about the...
The kitties. I just want to...
Listen, I just want the juicy shit, man. I ain't got time for all this treason stuff.
Well, where is it? Criminal Code of Canada? Let's see here. Let me see if I can skip to the good shit.
He's really hyped.
Keep putting that word in your search, Vaughn. Keep putting it in.
Uh-huh.
Well, I could have married her. That's
Number
what he's 44 thinking.
House Commons.
That's right.
Low age of consent, luring pedophiles to Canada. Oops. Tougher penalty for Child Predators Act. Aha. Now we're getting somewhere. Now we're getting somewhere, boys and girls. Oops, I got a loud.
Oh, his...
We're so close, I can smell the Pampers.
It's PDF. Hmm.
Oh, look, it's not a legal document at all.
All right, efficacy. Okay, we can zoom this in now, I do believe.
Here it is, folks. It's coming.
Forearm, maybe not. How do I zoom this in? Oh, okay. Whoa, too big. There we go. All right. After more than a decade of Canadian experience with sex offender registries at both the federal and provincial levels, policymakers can assess their efficacy in preventing crime and protecting the public. An evidence-based assessment can and should dictate how future sex offender databases are designed or modified and how resources are best allocated to reduce risk to society. Unfortunately, the Canadian experience with registries has not, in general, been positive. In 2007, the Auditor General of Ontario issued a report to the Ministry of Community Safety and Correctional Services identifying deficiencies in the administration of that province's sexual offender registration program. Okay, so apparently some sex offenders slipped through the crack. Boy, can I relate to that shit.
Oh, no.
Oh, that's beautiful.
Clip that, someone, please.
Oh, God, what is that? That's a 16-13. I'm going to have to take that fucking out.
He sounded like he slipped and said a gamer word earlier.
Yeah, I can't remember what he fucking spit out. Oh, my goodness. So, basically, long story short.
He relate to that? Yeah. Those slippery pedos, boy.
We're slipping around there through the cracks.
Just hose down in baby oil.
Because I think I found a few of them. I think I might have found some of them. What do you think? In 1998, the federal government, that's Canada, was clearly of the opinion that a national registry was not the best way to combat the problem of sex offenders. Since that time, it does not appear that there has been any evidence to suggest that offender registries are effective and successful in achieving their stated goals. In fact, there is now mounting evidence to the contrary. Okay, so. All right, we need to skip down a little bit because we could talk about that shit for hours.
I bet Vaughn could.
I bet he could. Wax.
In recent litigation before the Supreme Court of Canada, an affidavit by Superintendent Dave Truax, I hope I pronounced that correctly, of the Ontario Provincial Police provided evidence about the reality of sex crimes and supported authorities having current addresses for sex offenders. Sex offenders often lived, sex offenders often lived, worked, or had some other legitimate reason for being in the area where the crime occurred.
Okay.
Wow, what, did I have to listen? What? Like, how is that not patently obvious?
What was this? Okay, here's the evidence. Here's the bombshell, folks, that connects me to his fucking deluded theory, right? What is he trying to suggest, that I was there in Ohio?
Right. When the video Spoiler alert, pedos tend to have jobs that give them access to children. Spoiler.
Yeah, when you were 17, Vaughn, I was like 12 or fucking
Listen,
11.
Listen.
Listen. Says here that all postage must be sent through the clerk.
Double stamped.
Double stamp. Fucking, okay. Anyways.
Okay. But now, what does secular opinion say? What does secular opinion say? He says, oh, that video was just accidentally given to me. Really?
No, it was purposely.
Someone just accidentally gave you a video of a minor in a city and state and country that is not your own, and that and a minor that you did not know or have any knowledge of or any association with.
So again, folks, he was 24 in the video, but
And again, he just read a passage saying that pedos are usually commit the crime where they are. You're far away.
Yeah, and he's just like
trying to like wrangle you into that some kind of way.
You aren't even here. How'd he do it, right. Secular?
But he accidentally gave you the video. No. You were purposely given
the
video.
Yeah, I was given the video, which is counter-narrative
to his
narrative.
It was premeditated, Vaughn.
His narrative is usually, I seeked out people. That's what he seeked out people from my past, from when I was a right. little kid. That's what he tells people. And it's like, no, people that knew you when you were 24 gave me the VHS, Welcome to the Humble Commode.
Goodness gracious. I just love how, like, he stopped... When he and roped you are the opposite of what that little passage he read. You're the opposite of that.
Yeah, like every one.
But
of them.
That was ironclad. It was ironclad proof.
All right. Well, it was, you know, folks, I don't get it. I don't see the point. He's like Perry Mason here. He thinks he just fucking closed the case.
Shut it down. Yeah, he shut down the site.
Roll
he's
the credits.
Reading.
Roll the credits. We're done. Play the music.
Please tell us secular opinion. What have I personally done to you?
What does that...
What?
I don't even... What does that even mean?
I don't know.
Have I caused you money?
Yeah.
Have I caused you to lose your job?
We tried.
Have I done anything to you? Anything at all? Oh, that's right. Nothing.
Well, you slander me. You actually do slander and libel me. Well, libel, as you put it in writing?
I'm sure
somewhere in
comments.
Comments.
Yeah,
in comments.
I'm sure.
He has threatened that when he thought I was David Sandlin, he threatened to put all my stuff on gay sites.
That's right. He did. He did.
Yeah. And he's spread my docs around. So, anyways.
Not a damn thing.
Oh.
Nothing. Okay. So, secular has a problem. He has a real problem because he is in possession and has been in possession of a video where I am a minor. So, you have to ask yourself why.
Well, earned your copy.
But like I said,
folks,
Steve Kramer, the man in
the video
died at age 18, which means me and him had to have been 17.
So people have numerously posted this. It's a fact. You can look up the obituary of Steve Kramer. He died in 2010, folks.
Somewhere in that neighborhood. What was he, 40-something when he passed?
Well, maybe, yeah. He's around the same age as Vaughn.
I know I've seen a literal picture of his headstone, and I want to say it said 2014 for some reason, but maybe I'm crazy.
I thought it was 2010. I was pretty sure it was 2010.
You could be right. You could be right.
I could be right. You could be crazy.
Well, you know, I don't want to draw too much attention to it, maybe, but if you'll check the comments, we got a witness in here who seems to be extra knowledgeable about the contents of that tape.
Well, let's take a look. I have to switch it over.
X Hogger there. Dun, 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 dun. 2006, okay.
Oh, in 2006, he's saying? Okay, well, you know, we're getting hotter. The point
let's
is...
Scroll up a little bit more. See, right there. Yep. Go back up. There you go. Read that comment from X Hogger.
Yeah, I see that.
Yeah, he's been yelling at us. Hey, you dumb sons of bitches.
Sorry, guys. I haven't been able to see the comments the way we're streaming tonight. Yeah. I got you.
4-1 out for X Hawker.
1988. So you confirmed the video. I couldn't remember if it was 87 or 88. But yeah, it was 88, the video. Yeah. No, that's for sure.
Well, there you go. Straight from the Ninja Scorpion easel.
Yeah, right from the man holding the camera. Folks. All right, let's keep moving ahead.
Thank you for your service, Hogger.
Be 17. Now, maybe 17 isn't a minor in Canada. You might be able to make that claim. However, in the state of Kentucky and in the good old US of A, 17 is a minor. And so, yes, he literally was in possession of a video with a minor in it. Now, you have to ask yourself why. Why is that secular? I'm sure you have a perfectly valid excuse. Oh, I forgot. Yeah, oh, it just magically dropped in my lap. Right, secular? Yeah, bullshit. Bullshit.
No, it was given to him.
Bullshit, secular. Okay, this man is a pedophile, and he is in possession of paraphernalia that could be construed as a
paraphernalia.
And I just read to you. They like to be in an environment that allows them to be around minors. Okay, so we have to ask, what else is he doing? Well, we know it.
What? Where did he get that? What,
I don't know.
Where am I putting myself in an environment? What?
The internet? Is that what he's trying to say? I mean, you're there too, Vaughn.
I guess.
He played the drums, right? We know he played the drums.
Well, there you go.
Uh-oh, well, that's a red flag if ever there was one.
And we know that he was doing other things. And, you know, now I've
like what?
Heard rumors, but they're unsubstantiated. Rumors. You know, so I'm not even going to bring up rumors. I want to steal it strictly with facts.
Oh, yeah. Vaughn's going to stick to the facts here, folks. Everything coming out of his fucking mouth has been very... Well, he just read the law.
Hey, look, you're pwned, buddy.
Yeah.
He just read the law.
Right.
But we know he was a drummer.
Yeah.
And so we have to wonder if he had had any exposure to minors while he was doing drums of any kind. And so that's a good question, isn't it?
Well, I've had exposure to minors many times in my life, Vaughn, because I'm not a creeper or a concern. To be like, I can walk freely in the street and people don't look at me like, you know, I should get a restraining order against this guy just in case. So you, on the other hand.
Right. A preemptive restraining order.
Now, I will admit, for years I gave drum lessons and stuff, right? So that is a big difference there. People actually trusted me enough to pay me to be alone in a room with their kids, unlike people like Vaughn Helton, who, you know,
can't even be trusted to watch his own kids.
Yeah, the state is actively trying to keep him from his own kids. So those are just some parallels there, folks. Look at him. He's just the cat that ate the canary right now.
But yeah, folks, I was a minor. I was 17 years old in that video. I was a minor. Some of you are like, wow, I didn't know that shit. Yeah, because he ain't going to tell you that. what did he say? He said I was 24 or some stupid shit like that? No, I couldn't have been 24. Because Steve Kramer, the man in the video, died at 18. And he was my high school buddy. Me and him
used to listen to Ozzy
Osbourne together. And unfortunately, he drank himself to death. Which is sad.
17, folks. That's
17. Right. Hard partying 17-year-olds die.
Getting super chat here.
Yeah, Steve Kramer died at 18, which means me and him were both 17 in that video.
How long until Stinky says he never said the first Calvary showed he isn't stolen valor?
Right, right. Well, I have put out the challenge. I have my yellow card. I will show it again just for people coming in.
It's bona fide right there. Secular is bona fide. And yeah. Vaughn can say whatever he wants. Can't take that card out of his hand.
I've never seen Vaughn with this card. The official. Folks, it's right there. Can you see
it? There it is.
I'm doxing myself.
Read them and weep.
It's been out there for over a year, so it's okay.
Right, it's legal.
But that is straight from the First Cavalry Association. I want to be clear.
Hey, it's been in the public domain for 1 year. Well, Vaughn, how did it get in the public domain? Well, that's irrelevant. It's immaterial.
Right there, folks. There's the national headquarters. Now, explain that, Vaughn. Why would they send me a card with their direct address, how to contact them directly?
Laminated.
Laminated to be preserved.
That's as like, in last forever.
That's like the bat phone right there.
I mean, that really is. I mean, you basically have a medal.
Well, really. I mean, I wouldn't say that.
If you really think about it, you would never brag, right? Yeah. But that's what a medal is about. You can't point to it, but
I could say decorated. I would say decorated. I would decorated.
Absolutely.
Associate member, of the 1st Cavalry.
And just in case there was any doubt, we're getting confirming reports that Steve, in fact, thought Irv was a dumbass, too.
Right. Well, shocker, folks. There's the shocker.
Shocker.
Oh, my God. Look at this guy shove his face.
Look at that. Look at that ill intent on his face. He wants to murder that ice cream. Look at him.
Oh, yeah, he's mad and being stimulated at the same time.
Right.
Yeah, I'll go into jail.
So ask yourself why secular opinion. Oh, shit. Why secular opinion accepted a video of a minor?
Never happened.
Why did you do that? I'm sure you have a, perfectly logical explanation for that, right, Psycho? Come on now. But yeah, I mean what I say, Psycho. I am not even joking. You will delete all my videos.
This
that
is
you
why
made
we're
about
here.
Me. And you will leave Trolls, Haters, and Naysayers, and you will never do another live show talking about me, because if you do, I contact the Canadian authority.
Mm-hmm.
I show them the video
that you have on your
of
drive.
Me as a minor.
Why do you wait a minute?
Hold on. My friend Steven.
I'm
is
a
minor.
G-Man. Someone get a hold of G-Man now.
I have a super chat.
Fluffy Bunny donated $5 through super chat. Quasi says to check Von's Lover Slab post from March 2nd.
Yeah, I got a screenshot. I didn't know if you want to air it now or not, but Quasi sent it to me too. If you want me to get it to you, I can. It is it's a bit greasy.
Is it pretty greasy?
I mean, in this, you know, I wouldn't say it's the most shocking thing you'll ever read, but it's definitely grossly entertaining.
Well, here, let me open up my Discord. Give me a sec, folks. Pay no attention to the man behind the curtain. Huh. I don't know if someone's going to send that to me or...
One second, I'll get it to you.
Oh, I think Quasi might have... Oh, he's got it to me. Let me see if I can get it up there for the folks. God damn it. Let's try this.
Yeah, that should make it bigger if you open original.
Yeah. A sec, folks. And I should be able to zoom in on this. There we go. Alright, let's see what we got. So who wrote one? Okay, also take note of the part where it says if you're not using hardship, then don't use Lido patch. So if you aren't using hardship, that's the first thing you will need to remove. So this is somebody else, I think, but I'll just read it for context. There are many mods and patches which have been found to interfere with AAF, and there's a whole section here explaining what to avoid. In addition, there's a Discord link should you require additional support. So I'm assuming this is Von Helton responding.
I need G-Man. Someone get a hold of G-Man now.
Steve Ziguana donated $5.
Steve Ziguana.
Steve,
here we go.
Thought Irv was a dumbass, and he put my Ziguana scat in Irv's joints for fun.
By the way, if you couldn't tell, I can hear the super
chat.
Yeah. So.
Okay. All right. Good. Oh yeah, Steve's. Oh my goodness, that is a. That's
we
a
miss you, Steve Ziguana. We miss you.
Yeah, these times we need you. So, I think this is Von Helton's reply here. So AAF cannot find any quote dog meat male and female, okay quote unquote animations once you remove Lido and Crazy. Only dog meat and one human. Ah, you can't have a gangbang with a dog.
That's right. That's right.
I thought BP70 had these animations, but apparently not. The male player, dog meat, and the female, quote-unquote, victim. Okay.
Jesus.
This is getting pretty fucking
slimy.
What kind
of hellscape is this video game? Do you just log in and everything's fucking something?
It's just greasy. Yeah, this is fucking greasy. The male player, dog meat, and the female, quote, victim, end quote, are some of the best dog meat animations, in my humble opinion.
I mean, that's adamant. Like, he capitalizes that.
And I just think it's interesting that he's like a connoisseur. He's tried enough of the different bestiality mods to know that these particular ones tickled his fancy just right. These were the...
Listen, I have seen hundreds and hundreds of dog gangbangs, and I gotta say, these, chef's kiss.
Yeah, these are some of the best animations for dog rapes. So, someone will need to redo them now that AAF no longer recognizes them.
Get on that, nerds.
But I thought Vaughn made the mods. Wait, right. I'm confused.
He just works on them and repairs them, okay?
Folks, I'm confused.
You can't repair them if they're not there, you hater.
Anything illegal? Starts brushing his hair.
And I love it that he's got victim in parentheses. Like, ah, she's loving it. She's not really a victim. Cool, she's loving that shit. This victim. Come on. That's some liberal shit.
Yeah, that's pretty fucking greasy.
Oh, that's pretty good. That's pretty good.
Just a capper. So that's as of March 2nd.
Oh man, that's rough. That's rough.
Like a
dude.
Week ago.
So to anyone who's had any kind of correspondence with Vaughn on March 2nd, just know that somewhere in the back of his mind, he was thinking about a dog gangbang with a woman,
yeah,
and how upset he is. He can no longer view those animations.
Well, what am I gonna do now? You can't have gangbangs with the old. Get those good animations.
I can't just think that in my sick mind. I gotta see it.
Yeah, the victim.
The victim. That's the best part. That's the best. The female victim.
The alleged victim. All right. Anyways, folks. Fuck.
That you were in possession of. And they come down and they throw you in jail.
And we just read that and you're going to jail because you have a video.
You can't do that. Watch me, bitch.
Wait, Vaughn. Yeah, you have the same video, so... Wait a minute.
Catch 22.
In this timeline, I think you were in possession. The police will say, well, you were in possession. You say, but it was me, but whatever is so...
Law is a law.
Doesn't matter, dude. Fucking that. You can't.
No. Watch me.
Nope.
Watch and see if I don't.
He didn't.
You're going to jail, secular. Plastic You're going to fucking spoon. Jail, you pedophile son of a bitch.
And that raises the question yet again. Where did those dishes in the sink come from? Because everything he eats for the last fucking 4 years has been plastic. So I don't, anyways, it's a
mystery. Excellent question, and an even better question. I didn't really see the entire context, so maybe I'm speaking out of my ass here a little bit, so someone feel free to jump in and correct me. But didn't a couple of days ago, didn't he get paid to show his sink? And he said he was in the middle of cleaning dishes, but yet his hands were still dirty. So, does the water just come out of the spout dirty? I mean, what's going on here?
And to be fair... He didn't show the bottom of his sink. There could have been maggots on the bottom under all those fucking dirty dishes.
Right. He only showed one side. That's right.
Right. That had scummy old pond water in it. Looked like it was cupped out of Lake Alice and fucking trotted over to the fucking sink. Like, he ain't doing fucking dishes. I was just... like, it's like he was in the middle of building a barn. Right? Oh, you just caught me. I was just taking a break and building my barn. Like, no. Like, what? 3-day dishes quest? Like, it's a fucking...
Hey, listen, I take a week to do my dishes. I don't know how y'all do it.
I'm in the middle of doing them. Hater, I've been working on them.
Look at these hands.
They're filthy from this morning, so I haven't been doing dishes.
Well, the dishes are dirty, duh.
Yeah. But he eats out of plastic, where the dishes have been there for years.
How does he accumulate dishes? Yeah, they've been there for who knows how long.
Well, since
he had to feed another human. Yeah, right.
It's just like there's toothbrush fucking watermarks on the mirror. It ain't
Vaughn. Oh, that is glorious. Yeah, he's not brushing those teeth.
He hasn't wiped that mirror since the kids have been there. Anyways.
Fucking brutal.
Yeah.
There's not a damn thing you can do about it. Except whine and cry on YouTube.
Well, I guess we're whining.
That's all
and
you
crying.
Can do. Whine and cry some more on YouTube.
Mm-hmm.
You're going to jail, motherfucker. Well, Bob Hilton, why didn't you do this before? Why are you waiting until now? Oh, I don't know. Maybe because I got my channel permanently deleted. Who knows? What's the reason? Everything has its timing, folks.
This is when the time to strike a predator, right? If he honestly believed that I was what he's accusing me of being... Why now, Vaughn? Because I got my channel deleted. Had nothing to do with him, actually, but now I'll come out with the accusations of fucking that he's...
Yeah, listen, I have a strong policy. I leave pedos alone, they leave me alone, but if they strike my channels, they gotta go.
Yeah, trying to bring it out. Trying to fucking... Yeah.
That's another thing, too. You know, because the trolls get on here and they say, oh, look at Bond. Bond's, you know, the troll, you know, the god. Where's the gods at? Where's Von Helden's gods at? Where are they at? Where are they at? Don't you worry.
Where are they at?
Don't you worry. Everything's fine. Everything is fine.
Pinky up.
Do I look worried? Do I? Do I look worried?
Alfred E. Newman.
Do I look upset? Do I? The gods have a plan. And if you'd been paying attention, you would know what that plan is. You people that have been watching me for a long time, you know what that plan is. What is the gods' plan? What are the gods doing? What is their modus operandi at the moment?
Saving your children?
Saving that mattress?
What is their modus operandi?
Cleansing the land?
Those of you that have been watching me for a while, you know what it is, right? Fuck yeah, you do.
No one knows. You don't know. You can't even answer it. You're trying to figure it out.
Yeah, every time I'm about to mainstream a live stream, they're secular, right? Exactly. That's exactly right. And hello, by the way. I see you. You finally made it through your 3 months hiatus. Your 3 months baptism of fire or whatever. Let's see. I gotta mute that. There we go. Okay. Well, the audio is working. Okay, great. But yeah, we need to be asking some tough questions, right? Right? We need to be asking tough questions. Like, what is Secular Opinion doing with a video of two minor children?
What? Now it's two?
Because me and Steve Kramer both were 17 years old in that video. Steve Kramer died when he turned 18.
No.
I don't want to sound like a jerk or anything, but Steve Kramer looked like a lot of things, but a minor was not among them.
Right. I mean, come on.
He died of alcohol poison, I reckon. He drank alcohol like fish. But he died at 18. That's not my opinion. That's a fact. Steve Kramer, Hamilton, Ohio. He died at age 18. That is a fact.
Times two. Plus
now,
three.
Secular keeps lying to you motherfuckers, telling you that I was 24 years old in that video. No fucking way. Because Steve Kramer was still alive. There's no fucking way in hell I was 24 years old. So why then does Secular Opinion have a video of two minor children?
And by the way, Steve was like sit back in a recliner smoking a cigarette, watching TV. Like there's smoke everywhere. I don't want to say beer cans because I don't think there were any beer, but there's certainly a Pepsi bottle there.
Yeah, the date's 1987.
It didn't look like his mommy's living room. It looked like it was his house.
Well, yeah, it was where they're hanging out, and they're like selling guns. I asked him if he wanted to buy a gun.
At 17-year-olds hawking pistols.
Well, he comes from the mean streets of Cincinnati.
Remember? That's right. Right. Listen. All I can say about Cincinnati, especially in the 70s and the 80s, was they ran the streets like dogs.
That's right. So anybody who doesn't know what we're talking about, the Pepsi bottle, in the last frames of the video, there's a Pepsi bottle. And we actually had to verify not just the logo, but the actual font that they used. And they didn't use that particular font before 1987. And as it was validated in the chat by the person that actually shot the video, it was 1988. When the video was taken. So, in fact, Von Helton is not a time traveler. He did not go to the future, grab a Pepsi bottle, put it on the table, and then, you know, appear in a video when he was 17.
But this opens up an interesting possibility, Rolo.
Right.
Is that the Von from the Arm of Sagittarius?
Well, this is where it gets complicated, right? Because my timeline Von, right? Which brings up another interesting issue, which I've brought up many times before. He can't take us to court for alleged crimes from alternate me's and different, because that's not Vaughn.
Well, not the person from that universe, the person, the Secular Opinion from the Arm of Sagittarius would be the one, you know, in violation of the law here, not you.
Yeah, because I never did any of those things against our Vaughn here.
Exactly.
So, and, you know.
So we need to get the Men in Black to sort this whole thing out, because.
Yes. Yeah. It gets crazy, folks, when you try to really wrap your head around it. Because I don't think, but his answer to that was he told me that justice was blind.
Exactly.
So he's got me there. He's got me there.
Touche. I mean, you know, what do you say to that?
Something to the effect, don't matter, secular turnabout's fair play.
Ipso facto, Kentucky law.
Yeah. Don't matter. All right.
Because he's a closet pedophile? Maybe the Canadian authority needs to be informed of this matter?
Yes, yeah.
Hmm. You tell me. You tell me, guys. Huh? You tell me. But yes, this particular person is correct. Every time I'm going live, they're secular. There he is. There he is. There he is. There he is. Is he obsessed? Is he obsessed at me? Makes you wonder, doesn't it?
It's a morbid curiosity.
Yeah, it does.
I'll give it that.
Something is definitely not right, is it? And he's been dogging my ass how many years now? Come on now, don't shout me down when I'm preaching good. How many years has he been dogging my ass? A man he doesn't know, and a man that's never done anything to him. But yeah, folks, you didn't know that, did you? That video that he's got of me, I was a minor in that video, and so was Steve Kramer. We were both 17. Inquiring minds want to know.
Doing what?
Ain't that right? Fuck yeah.
What was even? It's just crazy, folks. It's craziness.
Yeah, maybe he's wanting that big red one, huh? Somebody said in the outside chat, maybe he's secular and wants you. And maybe he does. Maybe he wants that big red one.
I think he looks excited. It, course, look at him.
Straight as fucking arrow, boys and girls. But yeah.
It's probably J-Dubs in the sock trying to get him all
you gotta
lit up.
Ask yourself.
Hey, look, Vaughn. I'm playing with his pee-pee. Look, I'm owning him.
Two minor boys sitting in a room talking to each other. Huh?
Look at that. Look at these.
Inquiring minds want to know, secular. Huh? I think the Canadian authority will be very interested in my phone call, secular.
And the Canadian authorities have a stack of papers
on
you.
You need to get your mouth, and you need to delete.
It's eternal.
And I mean
the
permanently
white
delete.
Black ice.
As in any copies you have, fucker, of any video of mine. Any mention of me, anything to do with me. Because if they come to your house and they find videos with my name on it, secular, you go bye-bye. So it's in your best interest to make damn sure you delete
all
any
of this
copies
is just
that
a
you
threat
have of anything of mine.
Because he thinks he can scare you into deleting your channel.
Fuck
That's
yeah,
all this
is.
Is about.
You can't do this, Von Helton. You can't do that. Watch me, bitch. Watch me. You have a video of two minor boys in your possession, motherfucker. And I just read to you where they said anything like that is considered pedophilia paraphernalia.
He actually didn't
read paraphernalia.
He never actually got to the part where he actually made the connection.
He never could find it. He could just find postcards and treason.
Yeah, and then I believe the last thing that he was reading actually isn't like a legal document. It's like the mission statement of some like organization.
Yeah, right. Don't let pedos be daycare workers.
They're like lobbying for a certain bill to be pushed. So it had absolutely nothing to do with the law. It was like,
fuck
and
yes,
as ex-auger here points out, right? Like the camera didn't exist when Vaughn was 17.
Yeah. Oh no. Consumer. Yeah. We went through. The consumer camcorders.
VHS.
Yeah. Weren't even like available. Von Helton's a liar, folks. Shocker.
I just read the goddamn Canadian statute. So, yes, I can, and yes, I fucking will, secular. Bye-bye, motherfucker. Have a nice trip.
I'm still standing.
You're done.
I'm still standing.
Yeah, but Von, you could have done this at any time, possibly, couldn't you? Like I said, timing is everything.
Oh, really?
He's got you there, buddy.
10 years, I will.
Timing is everything, folks. Like I said, the gods have a plan.
Crimes.
And I tell you,
like
the gods have not abandoned me. Now, these fucking assholes out here on YouTube, they'll tell you, where's Von Helton's gods? Where's Von Helton? I assure you, my gods are in control. I assure you of that shit.
I'm not thinking so.
And they know exactly what they're doing.
I mean, you know, I
trust
tend
me on
to,
that, too. They know exactly what they're doing. And if you've been following me for a long time, the gods have specifically told me.
I tend to agree that he does have gods, but they're trolling him, or like they're opposite gods. That they say, yeah, sure, Vaughn, we're going to take care of you. And they snicker and, you know, take his property or take his kids or take his money.
Yeah. He's like the Job, but it's just an ongoing joke. They're just like, fucking, well, what else can we?
Yeah, but he's Job, but the devil and God are in cahoots. They're like, yeah, watch this.
Yeah, exactly. That's what I'm saying. They're all just like, well, let's. You know, don't collapse a house yet. don't want to flatten him yet.
Still lousy. Let it go.
Yeah, we got to give him the boils and shit first, so they're on the way. The leg scabs. That's definitely a...
What?
Oh, he's got those. Yeah. The nails of justice.
Yeah. Okay.
So use your brain. Think back what I've been saying all along, what the gods said they were going to do. And it all make perfectly good sense. There is nothing that the gods are not in control of right now.
There you go, ladies. Sprinkle some talcum powder in your britches.
Yeah.
Don't want to slide out of your chair.
Good old secular.
Try it up.
Needs to delete anything and everything to do with me. Or he's going to get a visit.
From who? The county Mounties.
Well, if they don't see jail time, it's not the point of it. The point of it is to get his ass in trouble. Okay, now if the Canadian government doesn't throw him in prison,
that's on the Canadian government.
And what does that say about a Canadian government that will not imprison a stalker? Right? I mean, he's been literally stalking my ass. And the Canadian government isn't going to throw him in jail for that shit? Well, that says a lot about the Canadian government now, doesn't it?
I love these cows. They qualify a stalker as someone who watches the videos they make.
Right, like, for public consumption.
Yeah, you watch this? You watched me speak publicly? You're a stalker.
Stalker. Yeah. How much money you send me? Oh, you're a stalker.
You're stalking.
Still going to have to go in front of a judge.
Look at that nose. What happened to the tip? Look at it.
And when that judge sees how many fucking videos he's done of this Von Helden character,
around where he shouldn't have been at midnight and nipped his ass.
Imagine his eyes would be that big.
He's back your ass up.
A little nip on the tip. Mm-hmm.
I reckon the judge would be like, why do you have so many videos of Von Helden, secular opinion?
Your Honor, I plead the lulls.
I would actually, you know how I would actually answer that? I'm like, have you watched his videos?
Right. Judge, I'm going to be impolite and answer your question with the question. Have you seen them?
Yeah. Obviously, you haven't watched them.
Oh, and by the way, folks, his name is public knowledge. So I can use his name legally because it's been in the public domain for over a year.
Yeah, but how did it get in the public domain?
His name is Ernie Chrysler.
Well, this is how stupid he is. Technically, my name has been in the public domain for like 40-some years, right? Because I live in the public domain. That doesn't mean...
But the question here, secular, is... Because, you know, he's a stickler for the law. And aiding and abetting a crime is a crime.
Uh-huh.
So how did that... So if it's against the law, unless it's out there for a year, how did it get out there?
Well, he put it out there.
He's aiding and abetting, right? Yeah.
So that's the Von Helden... the paradox, right? It's been out there for a year. So if I get your docs and I dox you, in a year it's okay.
Yeah.
Because I can use it again and I can say, well, it's been out there for a year.
the old one year law, he got us, man.
Yeah. Loophole. Liberal loophole. Thank the libs.
I need a piece of shit. Hey, Bon. It you can use his name, yeah. Mm-hmm. His name's been out in the public domain for over a year.
Well, not when you're attaching it to slander. It. Not really
he can get mad and stamp his feet all he wants, but I can legally use his name. Yes, I can.
Oh, Moz
Pills. Right, Ernie. Fuck that it is.
Yeah, time for medicine. I'm not right now.
Yeah.
Fuck roll. Yeah, it is.
She won't remember anyway.
His name's Ernie Chrysler. He lives in Canada. Now, I won't say where in Canada.
Well, you don't know.
Because that might get me in trouble. But his name has been in public domain. So. Anyway, good old Ernie. Yep, good old Ernie.
He's so mad.
What we have here is failure to communicate. ain't that right, boys and girls? Fuck yeah, it is.
Well, he scraped the plastic off of that cup, didn't he?
But yeah, his name is in the public domain. I can use his name legally. His name is Ernie Chrysler. I won't give out his address because, you know, I may not be able to legally do that. But I sure as fuck can use his name. So, such.
because I already did, but I found out it was fake and it wasn't actually real, but I tried. I tried to get people to attack his job and shit.
It'd be you, Ernie.
I just want to hassle the guy. Yeah, hassle doctrine.
Like I said, I think it's in Ernie's best interest to delete anything with my name on it that may be in his possession, and any backups, and anywhere it may be on the internet.
This is the most odd. Like, this is how he treated Andrea. This is how he treated Katrina earlier.
Right.
He's literally threatening you.
Yeah.
Right. All you got to do is delete everything, then you won't get in trouble. But you better do it. It's just so transparent, right? Mm. He's 100%. He thinks he's got you. He's gonna threaten you.
Yeah.
And this is the, like, he hasn't done this 1,000 times before, but this time it's gonna work because he pulled up the law.
Right.
And everyone saw it. He read about postcards and traitors.
Right. Exactly. He's got me.
Daily Motion, Live Leak, for example. BitTubers, BitChute, Rumble. Anywhere,
naming websites,
anything
now
has my name on it. It's in Secular Opinion's best interest to delete it immediately.
Oh, before I forget, folks, if you haven't already, make sure you visit Secular Opinion's Den of Dank. We got merch. There's a link right there if you want to help out. You can get Von Helton's face catered, just plastered all over everything over there. Making money hand over fist on the Von Helton.
Come on down, Kenny.
Come on down, Kenny. You want to check those out anytime, feel free, folks. Oops, what am I doing? I'm stoned. There we go.
Because they will go over everything with a fine-tooth comb. I guarantee it.
He's been through it.
So we will find out, boys and girls. So I'm being nice, generous. I'm going to be generous to you, Ernie, and I'm going to give you 30 days. Because that's usually what we give here in the States. We give them 30 days. Get 30 days, clean up the act. Get shit took care of. Get it, all your copies deleted, everything deleted. Get everything removed from YouTube. I will be checking, Ernie. I will be checking. As will other people be checking.
J-dubs.
And we will see. We will see how things go. I'm willing to give you a chance, Ernie. Unlike me, which you never gave me a chance, I'm willing to give you a chance. Let's see if you can clean this act up. You're not to mention me ever again. You're not to do any videos about me ever again. Because the day you do, the hammer falls. And the bell tolls for thee, motherfucker.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
Somebody says in the outside chat, I might know some concerned citizens, air quotes, that live near him.
Uh-oh, here come the threats. Uh-huh. They're legal threats, though.
Like I said, I mean, you know, it's awful interesting that this man has a video of two minor boys in his possession. And one has to wonder, okay, well, now, Secular, you lied to everybody and told everybody, these people in this outside chat here, few as they may be, but I know many of you are watching. But, yeah, I mean, you know, you lied to these people. You told these people in that video that I was 24 or 25 years old. That's a lie, Secular, because Steve Kramer died at age 18, which means me and Steve Kramer in that video were minors. We were 17 years old. Why do you have a video of two minor boys, Secular Opinion? Inquiring minds want to know.
Love the faces.
Says
in the outside chat, I think some Canadians might be interested to know, too.
Uh-oh.
What do you think?
Threat of physical harm. What do you think about that?
Call it a hunt.
I think, Vaughn, that when you just admitted that you haven't given out an address, and then people say, I know people that live near him, that they're probably trolling you because they have, what, Canada? Okay, they know people in Canada. What do you mean, Vaughn?
Canada's tiny. Everybody knows that.
By the way, Vaughn thinks I live in Ottawa. He already spilled the beans on that.
Well, yeah.
There is no honor. This honor that he's gloating about now, like, oh, I won't go that far. He's went that far.
Yeah, your next door neighbor's with Trudeau. We all know.
Down the street.
Yeah. Call it a hunch, Secular. You pedophile motherfucker. You pedophile son of a bitch. Like I said, folks, I've never lied to you. I've never gotten in front of this camera and purposely lied to you or anyone. And I never, yeah, and I ain't going to start now. And when I tell you that they are projecting onto me what they are, I'm telling you the absolute truth. I'm telling the absolute truth. I'm telling the absolute truth. I have no reason to lie to you ever. I have never, I can't get on here and call myself a truther and then look in this camera and lie to you people. Okay, I can't do that. I can't do it. Now, I'm not in a clear conscience anyway. See, unlike the trolls, I actually have a fucking conscience. I can't go around here getting people fired from their job or getting their kids taken away by the government or you know, shit like that. I couldn't do that, man. I can't do that. I got a conscience. I have to go to sleep at night. But yeah, I just think it's really interesting, folks, that you need to know what's going on behind the scenes, because you ain't been told. You ain't being told. In fact, you're being lied to. You are being fucking lied to. I wonder what Grampy Lobster is going to do with this information once he gets it. Once he finds out that Secular Opinion lied to his ass, because he did. I was not 24 in that video. I was only 17. And Steve Kramer was 17. Because Steve Kramer died at age 18. Look it up, people. Steve Kramer, Hamilton, Ohio. He died at age 18. Which means me and Stephen Kramer were 17 years old in that video. Yeah, buddy. Yes, we were. So why did Secular Opinion, a.k.a. Ernie Chrysler, why did he lie about the age, by age? Why? Why did he do that? Because he was in possession of pedophile paraphernalia, perhaps? Huh? You reckon? You reckon that might be why? Think, people. Use your brain for something besides a hat rack. Right? Now, have I contacted the Canadian authority? No. No, I have not. I'm going to be generous and give this man 30 days to get rid of everything having to do with me and the backups. Okay? Wherever they may be. Daily Motion, Live Leak. What's some of them other ones? Well, anyway, I've got them all wrote down. And I will be checking them all, Secular. Guaranteed. YouTube, all the video haunts. I will check every single fucking one of them and make sure that I am not anywhere there. What do you think about that, John?
So you're talking about this, the piece of shit, what's going on with him?
Yeah, he is in possession of a video of me when I was a minor child.
Doesn't he just look like a fucking rodent? Like, what are those things from Brazil or whatever that everybody's the fucking...
Capybara.
Yeah, he's like one of those fucking... They should be feeding him a fucking head of cabbage or some shit. Like, mowing it up. That's why he's always nibbling that stuff. Like, or fucking... He does...
Well, and this is in the break room at the Walmart where he's taking a break from pushing carts back.
Yeah, he's got his little rain jacket on. But they're yelling slurs at Mexicans and shit.
Right, by the way, he was fired from this job. I'm not sure how you get fired from Walmart, but he managed it.
Yeah, they hire, like, mentally disabled people to work at the fucking level that he was, right? And he couldn't hack it.
Really?
Entry employee level. He couldn't cut it.
Yeah, couldn't clear it.
He was hoping to move up to making being a sandwich artist at Subway. That was his next big
His dream, his goal.
Right.
God provides...
doing? He's going through archives and finding videos of you as a kid in the lock?
That's a damn good question, isn't it? Yeah, that's a damn good question.
That's stalking. Isn't that stalking?
That is very much so stalking, and I bet the Canadian authority will find it.
I like how they're completely acting like they didn't talk about this before.
Right, right, right.
Isn't that stalking, Vaughn?
Hey, J-Dubs, look what I found.
Yeah. Oh.
By what I found, I mean a video that's been around since 2010.
Yeah. Did you call the Canadian authority yet, Vaughn, or are you going to be generous? Oh, generous.
I'm going to threaten him first, J-Dubs. I'm going to threaten him and see if that works.
Right. Very interesting that he's in possession of a video showing two minor children.
That could be kind of rough, man. That could be kind of rough.
Yeah, that might be a little rough. Yeah, it might. And I'm glad you're here because Mom's pounding on my door. Let me go see what she wants. I'll be right back.
I gotta get back to work soon, but I'll hold down the fort until you come back.
Yeah, hold down. Just a second.
She wants her medication.
So I hope everyone is happy and healthy and doing well.
The alarm went off an hour ago.
If I was the judge, I'll send them to the gulag. That's what I would say. 30 days is very generous. I'll give him 72 hours to delete everything.
Reading
yeah,
stuff.
I say delete it now, or else you're gonna face the consequences.
Thanks, Quasi. Glad you're not prime minister.
So, how's everyone doing tonight?
Who's got the yellow vest?
Got to stay hydrated. It was 95 all day today, and now it's cooling off. But we got the thunderstorms on the way.
He wasn't even a cashier. He's directing people to the cashier.
Thunderstorms and storking.
Thunderstorm. Yeah. Vaughn, how you say...
It's the English. It's the Yiddish I speak. Come on.
Vaughn, Abraham. I can't...
I've been Jewish almost 2 years. English is falling away.
Delete everything.
How do you say...
I say delete everything now. This is where I work at the...
What is he, huffing Ajax?
Subway, eat fresh. So what's going on?
Eat fresh, man. Oh, just Mom handed me some mail.
What's the plan?
What's the plan? The plan was Mom handing me some mail. That's all. That's all.
Pallet instructions. How to make a pallet.
So you're eating fresh, right?
Well, unfortunately, I'm on my break, which is almost over. But I'm working hard, doing my thing.
Mm-hmm.
How's your day going, Vaughn?
Oh, that's all right. It's going all right. It's going okay. Everything. Wow, that's a big place, man.
Yeah.
Yeah. So that's a super center, right?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Shop talk with the
ones. Yeah, the ones here in Manchester, it isn't a super center. It's just a regular Walmart
store.
Yeah.
Well, I pushed a cart or two in my day, and let me tell you. Tell you, straighten that crooked wheel out.
Yeah. Now, the one in London is a super center.
But why is Vaughn on YouTube? That's a good question. YouTube is a bunch of pieces of shit. That's why.
Well, I can explain that, OTC, very, very simply. YouTube had a literal brain aneurysm and a massive dose of Trump derangement syndrome and decided to ban thousands.
Fucking John's out of there. He's like, yeet.
Of patriotic Americans because they were either discussing or streaming the Trump rally in Wayland, Ohio.
Well, you were sniping someone's the exact thing that you're complaining about now. You were sniping, but someone that had legal rights
right.
to cover the live events. That's the difference. And you were rebroadcasting. Of course, he denies us, even though he just admitted it right here. But that is the reason. Of course, now he says it's just because he's a Trump supporter.
That's right. What you don't understand is he was being stalked during a thunderstorm.
Right.
I think it was Wayland. It's Ohio. I know that. This past couple of days or so. And I haven't seen or heard anything yet, but I expect a lawsuit to be forthcoming in that regard. Because, you know, we have a right to talk about Trump. I mean, you know, they can get mad all they want, but they can't tell us how to think. Okay.
Well, no, it was because you were restreaming.
Yeah, you were stealing.
An actual conservative news outlet, apparently. And you didn't have license to cover it. They did. So they had it struck down. That's exactly what happened. That's, I mean, ay. Anyways, let's skip ahead through this shit. I don't want to hear him talking about fucking.
Guys, right now. So if you wouldn't care to give me a cup of coffee, down there's the link. I will post the link. Hopefully Twitch will take the link. Sometimes it does, and sometimes it don't.
Hey,
I don't know what's up with
Twitch,
that, Twitch.
Man.
You need to fix that, by the way.
Right.
Because sometimes when you post a link to Twitch, it doesn't take. It's like, what the fuck? Anyways. I will give you a direct link. Y'all can send me a cup of coffee. I'd really appreciate it. Because I literally, have nothing. And YouTube sent me a nice Dear John letter saying we're gonna permanently delete your fucking ass. You pro Trump.
That's not a Dear John letter, Vaughn.
Well, kind of, in a way, this one could be.
In a way.
Well, because they're divorcing him, I guess. They're saying, I guess, sort of,
kind of, if you know. I think he just means Dear John means bad news.
Yeah, I think so.
Some piece of shit. We're going to delete your motherfucking ads. Now, obviously, they didn't say it quite that way, but it says, hello.
Okay.
Well, thank you for your account suspension appeal. We have decided to keep your account suspended based on our community guidelines and terms of service. Please visit blah, 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 blah for more information. Okay.
So you just read the appeal. You didn't even actually read what the original, but it says clearly that you broke terms of service. So
okay, so apparently, if you are a conservative or a Republican or both, you violate YouTube's terms of service.
Why? Because you instantly, it's in the terms of service. You can't be a Republican. I didn't read that, but
isn't that wonderful? I cannot wait for this fucking shit to go to court. I cannot wait for the. I will crawl on fucking broken glass to get to that damn court. Because I can't wait to get on that stand and tell that judge what YouTube has done to me.
Cyrax
is next. And MIs is going to get big as saucers. They're like, wait a minute. You lost your marriage. You lost your wife. You lost your kids.
Check.
Because you wouldn't get off the internet. Yeah, they'd be amazed.
Well, I mean, listen. We are the most powerful entity in the digital space. Mm-hmm.
That's true.
You cross us, we will wreck. I mean, he's a toe away from being kicked out on the streets.
Mm-hmm. We did it, folks. It only took us like 12 years.
That's all it took, man. I mean, time well spent, as far as I'm concerned.
Mm-hmm. I just had this flash of this big class action lawsuit, and it's all the lulz cows from the internet's all taking their turn to testify. You got Cyrax in the lineup. You got fucking Emo, Von Helden, fucking Lucas Werner.
I just want to watch Emo give testimony and not scream.
Just spit all over his beard.
Just, I mean, filling that diaper up, boy.
My reputation.
They're incendiary.
Yeah.
Could have prevented that shit 15 years ago? Yes, sir. Yes, ma'am. All they would have had to done was enforce their terms of service. The very terms of service they say they're banning me for now. For being a Trump supporter. Oh, my God. So, apparently, YouTube thinks that being a Trump supporter is more dangerous than being a slanderer, a libelist, or a defamer.
Feelings hurter.
Actual crimes.
Feelings hurter.
Civil crimes.
Destroyer of reputation.
Actual crimes.
Yeah.
Whereas being a Trump supporter, last I checked, ain't a crime, YouTube. I'm sorry. It's not. Civil torts. Let's get the wording right. But yeah.
Well, to be fair, it doesn't have to be a crime for YouTube not to want you to be on, you know, on their platform.
I think YouTube's terms of service is designed to stop just short of crime, so they don't have to deal with it. That would be my
right.
Yes.
Though I would put out there the pirating a live event and restreaming it. I mean, that could be illegal.
I say it like this. When you download a movie like through a torrent site or something, you're actively stealing it. Mm-hmm. If you go to a streaming site and watch a movie, it's like your brother stole a bunch of fireworks and you watched him shoot them off, right? Like that's the distinction as far as I can tell. Mm-hmm. And Vaughn restreamed someone else's stuff that I'm assuming was behind a paywall of some type.
Well, I don't know if it was, they were streaming on YouTube, I think, freely. But only certain outlets had to pay to have access.
Oh, okay.
It was the Trump rally back in, it was like last year.
So Trump yeeted him.
Well, it was this news network that was there at the rally, an independent, like, kind of right-wing, I forget what their name
is. An ally, though.
The only reason I bring that up over and over again is because he claims it was the communist liberals of YouTube that yeeted him because he's a Trump supporter. Okay. But the irony, it was a fucking right-wing news, independent news outlet that fucking was covering the Trump rally, and they paid for access. So that's
sorry about your luck, Vaughn. They're turning on you. Yeah, well, maybe that's why he turned to the hardcore Stalinist communists. You know, at least they mean what they say.
Yeah, at least.
Yeah, apparently, slander, libel, and defamation have to take a back seat to being a Trump supporter, y'all. Isn't that cool? That's what they said. Let me read it again. We have decided to keep your account suspended based on our community guidelines and what? Terms of service.
He means he broke them.
Now, it's funny because I can't remember when I read their terms of service that being a Trump supporter was excluded. I can't remember reading that in their terms of service. Can you? Maybe they added it in.
I need G-Man. Huh? Someone get a hold of G-Man now.
J-Skull donated $5 through Super Chat. He's had nothing for years, but the gods are on his side? A definite misstep in logic in his noggin. The sooner this idiot goes away, the better.
See, I have to disagree with J-Skull here. Like, I know a lot of people want Vaughn fucking beheaded in the front yard. You know, like, they won't rest until that happens. But I like watching Vaughn suffer. I mean, this guy is literally eating trash out of the trash can at this point.
Yeah, I'm happy, you know? It's drawn out. I want it drawn out because I just want to watch the decline. Like, he's almost there at eating cat food. I mean, he's sharing the same food as a dog. So.
Right, really, I mean, he's been reduced to slurping out of like packets of ketchup and mustard. Mm-hmm. I mean, this is getting good.
Right, yeah, I want as much documented as possible, personally.
Right.
Maybe they added that shit in at the last minute. You reckon? Huh? You reckon they added that shit in at the last minute? No Trump supporters. But if you slander somebody or libel someone or defame their fucking character and try to get them put in prison, oh, that's okay. That's okay. But if you're one of them evil Trump supporters, oh, my God, well, you just got to pay, motherfucker. You're just the most evil son of a bitch that ever walked the earth. Right, YouTube? Yeah. Absolutely. Remember, folks. This group called Trolls, Haters, and Naysayers has gotten people fired from their jobs.
Now we're back to this.
Destroyed people's marriages, driven people insane. And
I think we just witnessed Mandela effect. I think he just switched.
He
got two different
bombs. He literally
bonds.
Did, yeah.
He just phased out. He forgot that he was accusing me of fucking heinous shit. And right. Now he's switched to fucking the oppression of the Trumpsters on YouTube. And now he's back to the Trolls, Haters, and Naysayers. It all comes full circle. Whoops.
Always. Always.
Got people's kids taken away by the government. Does that sound like a good group of people to you?
Say it again, though.
Or does that sound like a cadre of criminals and villains?
Cadre.
That's right. Good book.
I think it sounds like criminals and villains to me. You believe whatever the fuck you want. But that's what
I'm hive of scum and villainy.
Call me crazy. But yeah. Yeah, good old YouTube. Yeah. Yeah. We're gonna fucking keep you suspended because you're an evil Trump supporter. Oh, my gosh. You're an evil Trump supporter. Meanwhile, my kids are off in a far distant area out in western Kentucky crying to come home.
Yeah, he points out the window.
And, yes, they are crying to come home again, by the way. Hmm.
Just yonder past the dirty mattress.
So, very interesting, isn't it?
With that pile of adult diapers.
How much do I need to keep the internet on? Well, about $200, actually. About $200 a month.
You know, this because
I get the mobile device.
It goes from
$200
to $280. So depends on when you catch him is how much money he needs.
Well, the price of gas is up.
That's right. Right.
You got to deliver that internet.
It's $51 by itself. And that's what makes it so high. Supposedly, though, they're going to try and give me a reduction on my on my service. Hopefully I'll see that. I don't know. But yeah.
He's got free internet hooked up at Moz. Because he's an idiot.
That's about $200.
That is one of the best little nuggets that's come out recently. Is he was over there just gloating and stepping. And boy, Ronnie got over there and locked that joker up 12 hours later. Sorry about your luck, Mr. Hilton. Yeah, the internet's inside. You can't have it.
Yeah, call the company.
About $200 counting the mobile, because mobile is $51 all by itself.
Can't even win when someone gives him something.
That sounds harsh, I know, but of course I don't know. I mean, if I was out in California or up in New York, it'd probably be more than that, wouldn't it? Counting a mobile device, I don't know. You tell me, guys. I don't know that much about, you know. Admittedly, I don't know that much about mobile devices. Okay, so
say it again, Vaughn.
You know, I don't know that much about it, so.
I just imagine Von Helton and that Michelle Bess having a fucking
what a combo that would be.
Just repeating each other's sentences over again.
Like, do you think they can make a... I think they can make quite the handsome couple, personally.
Grampy lies. Grampy Lobster lies. That's what he does. He's a liar.
They need to
he
join
comes
forces,
on here and
man.
He's a liar. He tells lies. That's all he knows how to do. And support the racist founding fathers. He
well, help
racist.
Me out here.
Grampy's
help me
a
out
racist.
Here. Isn't Michelle Bess like the polar opposite of Vaughn politically?
I don't know, though. I wouldn't necessarily. She's on her own wavelength. The bubble party. The fucking, I don't know.
What you gonna do for me, party?
She just believes that friggin', you know, the whole system needs to collapse. So that she,
okay.
I mean, she's just as crazy as Vaughn. Like, you know. I would say she's legit, like, out there, though.
Okay.
Vaughn's just kind of out there, but he hasn't tried to metamorphosize into a butterfly.
Well, I know that human has threatened to kill Grampy on several occasions,
yes.
To which Grampy giggles at, so.
Uh-huh. Well, see the similarities?
Yeah. Let me give you guys, I can give you guys a direct link, okay? I'll give you guys a direct link. Let me pull it up here. There it is. Boom. All right. Buy me a cup of coffee, Maynard. Make sure you get that too. You got to get the whole thing, right? Because you got to copy the whole thing now. Don't forget the James Paul Von Helton because it's not highlighted. You got to get the whole thing. Make sure you got a Cash App account though first. You got to get a Cash App account, and then once you register and do all the rigmarole with Cash App,
can you send a penny?
Come
like
and get
one
the whole
penny.
Thing, but you got to get the whole thing.
I was actually going to comment. This is like a whole lot of fucking work just to give the guy a fucking $2 fucking. Give me a cup of coffee, folks.
If you put this much effort into like, you know, a real job, you can make quadruple that.
Yeah, right. Amazing. You can afford lemons. You buy all the lemons you want.
Right. You can fucking buy 100 lemons.
Okay. And you got to include the James Paul Von Helton in there. So there you go. There's your direct link, man. Yeah, boys, I tell you. But yeah, you know, it's time to start asking hard questions, isn't it, boys and girls? Yes, it is.
No, back
to, now we need to ask some more hard questions, like why does Sherry 226 encourage her daughter to make a video laughing at a woman who got raped on a Greyhound bus?
This is weird too. Like that, I haven't seen that Sherry account around and you know, I don't watch every video, so maybe they are around and I just don't see it, but they haven't been around in any meaningful way in a long time. Mm-hmm. He just dreamed that up. Like, you know who else I'm mad at? This person that yelled at me 9 years ago.
Right. Speaking of abusing minors.
Right. Had y'all heard about that one? Oh, y'all hadn't heard about that, huh? Yeah, she did. I've got the video. Well, a copy. I've got a copy of her video where she's laughing. And Charlie Miller, not to be outdone, got his daughter to do the same damn thing. Make a video about my ex-wife getting raped on a Greyhound bus.
I guess
that's funny now? Is rape funny now, guys? You tell me. I'm confused. Because now we got two people who got their daughters, no less, to make videos laughing about a woman getting raped. So I have to ask, is rape funny now?
I never saw those videos.
I don't know. Did I miss the memo somewhere? Because I could have sworn rape wasn't funny. I could have sworn that shit. Am I wrong? Somebody help me out. Am I wrong about that shit?
A clown getting raped might be kind of funny.
Because I could have sworn that rape wasn't one damn bit funny. Right? Hell yeah. I could have sworn that shit. Yeah. Apparently, rape is funny now, guys. You got Charlie Miller, aka Father Judgment,
district
manager,
who
got his daughter
JKK
to make a video laughing because my wife got raped on a Greyhound bus down in Tennessee. And I've got the detective's card right down there. The detective in the case. I've got his card right there.
This card that he's had for like 9 years.
Right.
Sure do.
So, just to be clear, folks, his wife got caught fucking a guy in the back of a Greyhound bus, and Von Helton has twisted it to save his fucking fragile ego on the internet that she got. Of course, it was forced by a black man.
Well, and you know, depending on when you catch him, this Father Judgment could have stopped it. Like, it waffles between he's the district manager of the Ku Klux Klan, and he sent a black man, which that's baffling to me, you know, that
right.
The Ku Klux Klan just has black people on retainer to send out to commit crimes.
Right.
Or he could have sent a bunch of skinheads to protect Andrea. He's mm-hmm. not sure which one he did or didn't do.
Right. Right. Yeah. Wow.
And then, like I said, Sherry 226 got her daughter to do it too. So maybe it's a trend. I don't know. Is it a trend that we get people's daughter? Maybe I should get my daughter to make a video laughing at one of the trolls and haters getting raped on a Greyhound bus. Maybe that, I don't know. Is that supposed to be a normal thing nowadays? You tell me, guys.
Just as it was just brought to my attention.
Yeah.
This is a guy who just wrote a comment about victims, quote unquote, getting raped by dogs.
Yeah, and his mods. Can we get that fixed?
Just throwing that out there.
Get that fixed. My gangbang mods ain't working.
Big ups to Quasi about people, for reminding me.
People getting raped. I guess people getting murdered in the street will be next. We can laugh about that too. That's funny now. I don't know. You tell me. I'm trying to figure this all out. I'm just trying to figure it out, people. You know? I'm just trying to figure it out, man. Help me out, somebody. Help me out, somebody. Oh, you didn't know about that, huh? Yeah, surprise. Surprise, motherfucker. There's all kinds of shit I bet you don't know. Huh? I bet there's all kinds of shit you don't know. How about Sean Merriman, a.k.a. George Bush Pimps, a.k.a. Steal This World, where he gets up and makes an internet meme about my wife almost dying on the operating table?
He did no such thing.
Make it a joke about it. On a live program. Making a joke about it and got everybody in the room to laugh too. They thought that shit was funny. A woman almost dies on the operating table, and that shit's funny.
You know what I'm gonna have to play. It's out there somewhere.
But I'm the sick one. Really?
I'm the one with a mental deficiency.
Really?
Like the circumstances of what he's talking about were he accused George Bush Pimps of ripping her. George Bush Pimps was doing whatever, and Von accused him, "You ripped my wife's cervix." And he was like, "What the fuck are you talking about?" So he's like, "Oh, sure, yeah, I just ripped her cervix." And that became him making a meme. Von accused him of something ridiculous, and when he laughed at the absurdity of it, that was him making a joke.
Cervix ripper.
Goodness gracious.
No, I'd say laughing at somebody almost dying on an operating table, I think that totally undoes anything that I've ever done. Pretty sure. But yeah, use the Google Wayback Machine. Okay, do this. Go to the Google Wayback Machine.
What is it with these idiots in the Wayback
cervix,
Machine?
CERVIX.
I gotta do it.
You have to.
I'm using my own Wayback Machine.
The good Wayback Machine.
Bear with me here, folks. I got it here somewhere.
Look at this. Look, Von eating.
Oh, there it is. Folks, the audio is probably horrible.
Deal with it.
Slander, libel, defamation of character, putting my children at risk, putting my wife at risk. My wife was in the hospital, folks. My wife is in the hospital over this shit. Y'all put my wife at risk. And I can prove it from a doctor's statement that it was stress-related. The stress of what? Stress of CPS? Stress of trolls? Stress of the haters? Not knowing if some fool's going to call CPS and take her kids away again? Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. And that can all be laid square at the feet of the YouTube trolls. Ain't that right, Mr. George Bush Pimps, who admitted live on video that he called CPS to get my kids taken away? Didn't you, Sean Merriman? It's going to be glorious. Throwing these motherfuckers in jail is going to be glorious. Can you have some of that money? I don't know. We'll see. you can bet your ass that the settlement I get in court ain't going to be tiny. Three little innocent kids at risk?
Ooh, look at the nails,
fuck yes.
Boy.
I'll be allowed to sue for the maximum, folks. Bet on it. Bet on it.
This is post-Mouse, too. The Mouse is
But I just thought I'd come in here and take, because I know y'all are recording this shit. No, I know y'all going to post this to YouTube, so go ahead. Please do. Bryn Cross. Old Dayton Pike, Soddy Daisy, Tennessee. Yeah, we'll be knocking on your door there, buddy. Me, the sheriff, and my wife will be knocking on your door.
All three of them.
We'll be knocking on your door. It's going to be glorious. Might even post that shit to YouTube. You never fucking know. But we're definitely going to be paying you a visit. Because I know you ain't going to take down your Encyclopedia Dramatica page. You're too fucking stupid. You're too fucking stupid to do so. And you got too much ego. You know, it's funny. The trolls and haters want to sit there and call me a fucking narcissist when they got ego out the fucking ass. But that's okay. Hey, you know, it's all good, man. It's all good. When the sheriff arrives and you ain't deleted none of your shit or got your shit taken off the internet, it's all going to be right there. Bam, bam, bam. Off you go. Computer gets seized. You go to jail. Then I end up suing you on top of that. For at least hundreds of thousands of dollars, three children at risk? Oh, fuck yes. That's at least a $100,000 settlement, dude. At least. Ask any lawyer. Okay? So, yeah, not only are you going to jail, but you're also going to lose probably your home, probably your car, if you got it. If you don't, then anything of value is going to be gone because you have to sell it in order to pay me. That's going to be funny. That's going to be funny. Because you have to sell all your shit in order to pay me my settlement. Isn't that going to be great?
Yeah,
that's going to be great, Brent.
Get it, Vaughn.
And then on top of that, the police, where you claim that you're a member of MS-13 or at least an associate of MS-13, a gang. Oh, yeah, the police are going to love you, buddy. Police are going to love you.
The notorious MS-13 internet gang.
Mm. The audio comes back here.
Now, y'all make sure you put this up on YouTube real nice now so that Mr. Brent Cross gets my message good and clear.
Pardon me, folks.
Because me and the wife and the sheriff are paying him a visit soon.
I think he's still waiting on that visit.
Oh, and by the way, Brent, if for some reason you are not there, you'll be considered a flight risk. Which means there'll be an APB out for your arrest immediately. So you better be home. Better be home when me and the sheriff show up. Because if you're not there, they're going to consider you a flight risk. And there'll be an all points bulletin out for you nationwide. Won't that be grand? Won't that be grand? Won't that be fun? Won't that be glorious?
Can you imagine?
Yes, it will.
Mightn't it?
Fucking nationwide. We got someone that hurt Von Helton's feelings on
that. You know that guy on YouTube called You Are Not the Punisher that's talking shit about me all the time? Yeah, that's Brent Cross. That's Brent Cross. Brent Cross is You Are Not the Punisher. He also has another name on YouTube called You Are Not Anonymous, I think. But he's definitely You Are Not the Punisher. He's the one that made the Encyclopedia Dramatica page.
He's so mad.
That guy was really funny, by the way, that You Were Not the Punisher.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, he's a real piece of work. Claims to be at least a friend of MS-13, if not an actual
El Trollo. Gone, but not
forgotten.
What does
he look like? He's a 20-something dude. 20-something looking. Just like most of them. Most of them are in their 20s. They don't know what the fuck they're even doing yet. They got nothing better to do, so they just fucking troll and hate people. But now, don't forget, folks, some of these trolls and haters were actually killing young girls. They would harass them until they committed suicide.
That's
so
another
that
arc
mind.
That he's...
Now,
that
I don't
I
know if Brent Cross was
time.
One of those types, but it doesn't matter.
Huh.
But yeah,
remember,
from his picture, he looks like a 20-something.
His origin story, you know, like all of his stories, they change depending on who his audience is. But
excuse me.
It goes from I came to YouTube because I liked watching women put on makeup tutorials, and he was going to help them.
Right.
To someone played a video. There was some kind of high profile case where a girl did something drastic. I think her name was like Amanda Todd or something. And then he blamed the trolls on that, right? Like, because that caught some nationwide heat. He said, "Oh, that was my trolls did that. That's why I come to the internet,
right? Come
to save young girls.
Yeah.
Right?
Just like Kelly, I was trying to save.
That's right. That's right. That's right.
Offering her refuge.
But that's all right. It doesn't age. You know, he's old enough to go to jail. That's all that matters. He's old enough to go to jail, and if he isn't old enough to pay me, then maybe he can get a loan from his parents or somebody. But he gonna pay me, that's for sure. I'm gonna get paid. Putting three of my children at risk? Fuck yeah. Three little children put at risk because of this shit. You don't think the judge is gonna award me big? Fuck yeah, he is. Fuck yes, he is. You can bet on that.
But that was
this is strictly an opinion, because
that was the birth of the cervix ripper, though. At the beginning there with George Bush pimps. The first mention of it.
I feel like this is, because you know he had a couple of stints where he went back to stick cam, and when the cervix ripper stuff happened, I hadn't discovered Vaughn yet, and I remember this. I remember being in the room for this, but maybe my memory's faulty.
He may have said it on Blog TV or something previously, yeah. But basically his argument was she had hemorrhaged and was having problems, and the doctor said she was having problems healing because of it was stress related, right?
Right.
And Vaughn Helton said, "Well, of course they're stressed. YouTube trolls fucking harass me all the time, and she's got to listen to it, right?" So basically, right. Living with Vaughn was the stress, but he just wouldn't accept it. He blamed the trolls, but it's just funny because, you know, he's like, George Bush pimps is responsible for ripping my wife's cervix, right? It's just like,
right. And from then on, he was the cervix ripper.
Yeah, cervix ripper, OG.
I'm not a judge. I'm not the lawyers. But if it's under 3,000 per child, I'll be shocked. I'll be shocked. Because I'm going for the maximum.
Here's Vaughn valuing his children's lives.
So
if it's
under 3,000 per child, I'll be really shocked.
$8 billion.
Right.
Well, then his parents is going to have to bail his happy ass out. You know? That's the way it goes, man. Tough titty said to kitty. And if he can't pay, he stays in jail until he pays it out.
Like how he decides how it works.
Well, I just think it's interesting that he now has to pay.
Right.
So, is he going to be in jail soon?
Oh. Well, I'm sorry, but I can't do nothing about that, Jeffrey Dahmer. The only thing I can do is protect my children from internet trolls.
Sorry about your luck, Ted Bundy.
That's the only thing I can do. All right? And my kids will be avenged by me. Bet on it. Did you all know that my children have night terrors now because of their experience with CPS and foster care? Did you all know that?
I don't know what to tell you, Ted, because it's
true. My children have night terrors because of this shit.
They have night terrors so bad they scream over top of me at 4 in the morning. I don't know what would be waking up my kids and giving them terrors.
Do you remember him saying, "No, my kid's room is soundproof. I put cork on the wall."
It's 70 feet on the other side of the trailer. I mean, like, you know, it's right there, right? On the other side
it's
of the
behind his head, yeah. Yeah.
Well, yeah, it was 70 feet away and they were fucking insulated with cork. It's like, who would do, why not just, why don't you just stop yelling at 4 in the morning? It's in, no, I insulated it. It's all good.
They can't hear me.
Put up egg curtains. Ugh. I believe they had night terrors, though. Listening to that, can you imagine?
God. Oh, dude, there's no telling, dude.
Sounds like someone's getting murdered every fucking
night. I mean, you know,
that
when you
horse vag fucking shit going
right.
on.
Right. You gotta choose between going in there to tell daddy to shut the fuck up, and if you do, if he's loud, at least you know what he's not doing, right? Beating off to fucking dog meat, raping all the women of the village.
The victims, yeah.
Right.
The trolls and haters of YouTube have done actual, documented damage to my children as a result of their activities.
Logical
I can
damage.
Prove it medically.
Logical damage, folks.
Physically.
Troll accounts.
And I can
I need
sure
to see
as
some
hell
logical damage
portable.
Accounts out there.
Nah, Zim, there isn't. But you know what? That's okay. I want this recorded. I want Brent to know I'm coming for him. I want you to know I'm coming for you, Brent. Me, the sheriff, and the wife will be on our way.
Brent was never
came
for.
I don't know when, but we're definitely going to be on our way. So whatever you do, don't leave the state.
So he's going to pack up Mouse. They have no vehicle, but I guess the cop drives, right? And they're going to get his local sheriff to drive wherever this guy lives.
Right.
It's like Kentucky, the Manchester sheriff fucking shows right. up in fucking whatever, South Beach fucking.
And not for nothing, and, you know, I don't know the guy, you were not the Punisher, but I don't think that the docs were correct. They were just some bullshit that was spewed out there.
Yeah, probably.
The reason I say that is because this person at the time was like a 45-year-old like sports memorabilia collector. And it was like, yeah, the kid, I'm pretty sure I talked to him at least once in stick cam, and he sounded really young. Mm-hmm. So I don't think that it was quite right, but, you know, I don't know.
Right.
Don't leave the state, because you automatically be labeled a flight risk at that point, and they
He's
will
just
put
always
out an ATV
threatening,
for your
always
ass.
Abusing, you know?
Right, yeah. Trying but to manipulate the situation.
We're coming to get you. Your time is up. And I know you're too stupid to take down your shit. I know you are. That's what I'm counting on.
Listen to his reverse psychology.
I'm counting on you being.
Because that's all he wants, is the channel deleted.
Right.
Polly Customs that lives with Sean Merriman. Yeah. Don't worry. We'll get to Polly.
See, this is another one. Like, he knows 100%
but,
that's his name, where he's at. He's known all along. Never done a thing.
If I'm not mistaken, you are not the Punisher started harassing me before Sean Merriman did. So it's kind of fortuitous that it's actually going in this direction, because, you know, I'm kind of like doing them in chronological order almost, you know. So it'll work out. Don't worry, guys. Anybody that had any involvement with hurting my children is going to pay, and they're going to pay dearly. Bet on it. Okay, especially now that I got some money in my pocket. Oh, fuck yeah. By the way, I have an interview coming up next month.
Oh, this is, you remember this?
And, you know, I'm going to be paid rather handsomely for that, which means I'll have even more money. And as a result, I'll be able to come after more of you sick motherfuckers.
Yeah, this is when he was trying to charge $2,000 for an interview.
Well, no, he was, and someone I think was trolling him. But I think this may be, remember when he went on the Blog Talk radio show? And George Bush Pimps went on the show, and they kicked Vaughn off and kept Sean?
Yeah, that happened after that.
I think, did it okay.
Well, because that's actually what led to the $2,000 interviews or whatever, I think, eventually.
I think you're right, yeah, because he got made fun of in front of billions of people.
Yeah, he thought it was coast-to-coast fucking, yeah.
I really wish that was still out there. I know that GBP did have a copy of it, but it was just his side of the conversation. I don't think you could hear. He was on the phone, I think, if I remember correctly. So it was kind of, the audio wasn't great. Right. But if you weren't there for that, that was some, I mean, mwah, chef's kiss.
Oh, he was.
It was some good stuff.
It's supposed to be his interview. He crashes it. The guy's kicked.
Well, you know, put it in Vaughn's terms, right? Like, he thinks he's about to go on to this huge, big time professional show. Which, I mean, it was like a Blog Talk radio. For those who don't know, it was. Anybody could do it, you know. To put it in perspective, Rev did one of these, so right, there you go. But in Vaughn's mind, it was like coast to coast AM. It was a big deal, and they were taking callers. And George Bush Pimps called in. They started arguing, and George Bush Pimp kept his cool and didn't use curse words. And Vaughn just flipped out, started screaming cuss words at him. So they warned him, and then he wouldn't stop. So then they had to kick Vaughn off, and then they kept GBP on for like 30 more minutes talking.
Yeah.
It was grand.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Vaughn hates that to this day. He's still, he just, yeah.
So, yeah. Yeah, it's going to be glorious. I'm telling you, it's going to be lots of fun. Lots of fun. Because I'm not playing. Okay, you put my children at risk. You've damaged my children, possibly beyond repair. And so, yeah. I'm coming
out.
So
happy about it. Look,
you don't hurt somebody's
kids. I get more money
for
them damaged kitties.
You don't put somebody's kids at risk. Sorry.
Now I want them back.
I don't know about playing the stock market. Stock market's all fake anyway. You know it went down 100,000 points, right? When it crashed a few years back. Went down 100,000 points. Okay, so anything you're seeing
yeah,
right
stock
now,
market's all fake.
You have to
we'll
subtract 100,000 points from that, and that's what the accurate reading is.
Just subtract.
You say, well, Bon, the current numbers are only 10,000 points. Yes, I know. Which means right now the stock market is actually operating in a deficit.
He's so smart. You know, I don't know if it's feasible for you or not, but I know a couple of people in the chat here were asking about the video you were going to play that started out with, you better stop me.
Oh, yeah. Did I have it on this list? Let me take a look.
I think you did.
Well, I had it over on the other one.
Oh, okay.
But it was running like shit, but I think I put it on here somewhere. Maybe I didn't. What's this one? I can't remember what it was called. Give me a sec here, folks.
You better get me. Thanksgiving leftovers. I love these, dude. We just need to do a video of you titling your fucking funny ass shit.
Where's the Von shit? Oh, the cervix. Huh? Where did I see that? Where did I grab that video from? Was it Andrea?
A Russian.
Yeah, that's a whole nother story, that one.
Andrea Safehouse.
Yeah.
Oh, shit.
When we put it up on eBay.
Oh, God, that was so good. Who played that? That's so good.
I think this is the one Dr. D made. Because the one that I made, you suggest that song, Andrea?
That's right.
But listen to this fucking shit. He put the fucking Andrea Safehouse tapes on eBay. And fucking, by popular demand, hear her side of the story. Listen with white-knuckled anticipation as Andrea Von Helton dishes the dirt, revealing every juicy, candid detail of life inside the dank FEMA trailer her captor forced her to call home. This auction is for the full, unedited, infamous Andrea Von Helton Safehouse interview. Over 2 hours of raw footage, folks. Sex, abuse, guns, and skid marks. Oh, my God.
Oh, good times. Good fucking times.
Oh, God. Yeah.
Minor has become major. That was the... Just by the titles, I know these.
Yeah. I don't know. I can't remember where I saw it. Maybe it was down in the... I mean, we got so many folks. You don't know. Who knows where we're going to end up with these folks.
Von Helton gravy. Games and horse vagina.
You got to keep track of this shit.
Wolverine, you got a Wolverine folder? You got it all.
Oh, yeah.
Von
horse vaginas. Oh, there we go. God, if I die and people find this shit. Homosexuality is evil and satanic.
Yeah. For the life of me, I can't figure out homosexuality in bathing suits. There's the old fat hillbilly. I know that one.
Yeah.
Hello out there. That's numero uno. That's the very first one.
We played it at the beginning.
Yeah.
It's all over the place. Oh, I can't remember what it was called. That was basically when fucking Mouse and Ma were fighting.
Yeah, it was like
I'm gonna kill her.
That was the preamble to the dance and the pizza.
Right.
I remember right.
Okay, yeah. God, some of this shit, I don't even know what this stuff is. YouTube cease and desist.
I remember that. He had that on his blog TV channel forever. That was the proof that you had to leave him alone.
What is this? PSASH after show. Oh, it's like 2 hours. God damn. You know what? Fuck it. Let's just go and hit fucking...
Yeah, it's just a grab bag, maybe.
These are just
yeah.
the loose ones. What do we got? Moon Melt.
Oh, no. Moon Melt. Yeah, yeah. Lister 09. Let's see. Coney 2012. Not hardly.
Mouse Trolls.
Mouse Troll.
What the hell are the mouse tapes?
I don't know. How long is it? 2 minutes 41 seconds?
Let's find it out. Let's find out. Oh, the
you
fucking...
Oh, yeah. That's why you got him labeled that.
That's
what
I
like,
sent
here you go, Vaughn. Here you go. Here's the mouse tapes. And it was this.
Kenny KBZ, 1979.
Oh, man. Good time. He got with that joke in 2010 and then got again in 2014.
Yeah. I've got to make you understand. Never gonna give you
up. Never gonna let you down. The agency.
Oh, God. All right, enough of that. My real name is Frank.
2011. That might be when he's talking about his experiences. I think you got some screenshots there from Mouse's Facebook when she's like, you know, telling
over
the
here?
Truth. No, above. Go up one. Right, go straight up. Yep.
Oh, yeah.
Nope, no, right here. I'm doing this like you can see my mouse. You see where it says mouse broke? Go right next to that. It's mouse and a bunch of September 26th.
Oh, yeah. Oh, let's take a look. Let's bring it over here.
Oh, is this the one where they ate aspirin?
Helena, yeah, this is when they had to take Helena to the hospital. My oldest is at home. I don't know, just talking about getting the kids weighed and stuff, but yeah. I can't remember, was that when they swallowed the pills or when he... Oh no, remember she had to go to the hospital because she hurt her wrist from...
Trying I to do.
Oh, there's James Paul. We are not... He's jumping in. We are not allowed.
They have we have us
listed as danger to the children.
And this is years ago. This is like 7, 8, 9 years ago.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, he's making excuses like we cannot take him to the hospital.
And we just dropped her off at the hospital. We just dumped her out. We can't stay there. They won't let us.
Yeah. Ninja, Psyop, Random. I don't know what some of these are, man.
some deep, dark secrets.
There's some
this
shit.
This motherfucker, if you ain't careful.
The sun is not hot.
I remember that. The sun's cold. Cold sun. Oh, man. And there was another one. I know that's another one that's been lost to time. Is when he's got the peach blouse of Mouse's on. And he's just doing the video.
Yeah.
Oh, it's so good. Von Hilton tells the truth.
Yeah, I don't know what that is. Can't lie, I'm a truther. Von Helton the Groundhog.
Oh, that's a good one. One of the most, Von Helton, the most powerful wizard, slanders his family.
What is this one?
That one looks familiar.
Yeah, that's not super old. I think he's taking us all to court again.
Alrighty, folks. The little red sign says we are live. We
His
are live.
His titties haven't
live.
Come
and
all the way
so.
In yet.
I just thought I'd hop in here. I actually went to bed about 6:30.
The closet's closed though.
And didn't stay there
it
for
is.
Very long.
That's weird.
So
he's got one lone sausage right there, just all by itself.
And I thought I would come in here and say hi. It's
bedtime.
And
well, that's bedtime the game you can play. Is it feces or is it food?
I am. Wondering what's going on. Of course, you know, I believe that the gods are with me. And I believe that they know what's going on. They have their best interest at heart. They have my best interest at heart. They have them kids' best interest at heart. Of course, I don't understand why they allowed these assholes on YouTube to harass me as long as they did. But I'm sure they have a reason. And the problem is that now I want retribution for that. So I don't know. And good evening, Blake. How you doing? I also noticed that Trolls, Haters, and Naysayers, an internet terrorist group funded and controlled by Google, been watching my shit and posting it on their Google page.
They've been watching and posting.
But that's not anything new, because Google loves internet terrorism, don't you, Google? Yeah, you love that shit. That's why you fund these motherfuckers. That's why you protect them. I mean, how many times have people flagged this fucking channel down, Trolls, Haters, and Naysayers, and Google has done nothing? Google leaves it setting up. So I have to believe that Google supports internet terrorism. Otherwise, they would have taken down Trolls, Haters, and Naysayers channel. Not just for slander or libel or defamation, but just for flat-out hate speech. I mean, my God, hate speech, harassment, stalking. I mean, the list goes on, and yet Google refuses to take this fucking channel down. So I must assume that Google is complicit in internet terrorism. I have no choice but to believe that. Now, if Google wants to change that opinion, then they need to delete the channel Trolls, Haters, and Naysayers. That's simple enough, right?
Do what I say, Russ. Yeah, I won't like
it. Simple enough for me. Problem is that they won't get rid of Trolls, Haters, and Naysayers, because Google is funding Trolls, Haters, and Naysayers. That's why they've been doing what they've been doing for over 10 years.
My fat check.
Because no sane, rational individual is going to stick to somebody that they don't like. And they sure as hell ain't going to do it for no 10 years. That's just fucking insane. All right, so what's going on here? Well, they're being paid, obviously. Something's going on. I mean, they've got incredible power. They can sit there and contact VidMe and literally shut down VidMe to the point where VidMe won't talk to anyone. That's a lot of power.
Now, this is
so
VidMe days.
I must assume that they have the power of Google behind them. Otherwise, they wouldn't be able to do what they do.
DHN, powered by Google.
And so, that's right. You know, I can't wait for this lawsuit from PragerU to take off. Because I'm going to give PragerU every bit of information that I've learned over the last 10-plus years in regards to Google and YouTube and how these assholes have tormented me and my family and tortured us mentally. You know, my poor ex-wife was tortured mentally. She was. She would be told by the trolls, "Don't do anything. He's a slave driver. He's slave driving you, Andrea. You let him do all the work." And so Andrea would lay in the bed and not do any work. Yeah. Well, then here comes my family, who, by the way, is friends with Trolls, Haters, and Naysayers, I now know. And well, they come in and see her laying in bed, and they say, "Get up. You're a wife and a mother. Get up and act like it and take care of your house." Okay, so Andrea was getting the opposite signals. Mm-hmm. All the time, back and forth, over and over and over again. And her brain went, snap. And that's exactly what the fuck happened. Simple as that. So, I have to believe that Google is perfectly okay with a group of people that like to destroy people's marriages.
I would like to point out that she was hearing voices telling her to kill her parents before she moved in with Vaughn. If that's any, you know, I think she has already snapped.
You're just putting that out there.
And she'd have all these crazy dreams, and he was, like, propping it up. He's, like, egging it on. He's like, "Well, that's a prophecy."
I remember that.
The world's going to burn.
That like to get kids abused under foster care. That like to harass people for 10 years. That like gang stalking. That like internet terrorism. That like to try to get people's online businesses destroyed, which they did. I had an online computer business, if you'll remember.
He never did.
And they, what did they do? They run off all my clients. Well, obviously, if you run off all my clients, my business ain't going to last very long now, is it? All right, so, you know, Google apparently thinks this is perfectly old fucking K. Otherwise, they would have took down Trolls, Haters, and Naysayers years ago, right? Yeah. So I have no choice but to believe that Google is complicit in this group's terrorist activities. Now, I know some smarmy idiot out there is going to say, well, internet terrorism ain't the same as real-life terrorism. The fuck it ain't. The fuck it ain't. There are real people on the end of these computers. This is not some fucking game. All right? This is not a game. This is not funny. There ain't a bit funny about this. These people have terrorized my family for 10 years, and Google and YouTube were complicit. Google and YouTube sat on their fucking ass and did nothing. And so YouTube and Google are going to get sued. So when Prager University launches their lawsuit against YouTube and Google, my happy ass is going to at least be there by video. I may not be there in person, but I sure as fuck can video conference via Skype. And the courts will hear every goddamn thing that's been done to me, my ex-wife, and my kids.
Oh, Jesus.
Man. And the court will know about trolls, haters, and naysayers. They will know about the Honor Network by Lenny Posner.
Just the same over and over. But I just imagine sometimes, like, you know, like an alternate reality where they actually do give him his day in court, and it's all these people just serious, these people of distinction, right? People of legal pedigree, right, all sitting around this like fucking chamber listening to his testimony. You know, just
yeah, just utter madness. And you know. To the viewers out there, like, for me, when I see these videos, even though he's pretty much saying the same thing in this video that he said in every other fucking video we watched, I remember the timeline, so I remember what was happening, so it's, like, nostalgic for me, right? And I get how that wouldn't be for, if you weren't around back then, I can see how it kind of would be repetitive, but that's why we love him, man. He does the same, he's very predictable, if nothing else.
Right, yeah.
They will find out with evidence that nobody died at Sandy Hook or Boston bombing.
We don't condone.
Yeah, that, might not want to keep going.
Well, let's jump past that a little bit.
Fucking perp walk. I'm going to enjoy the fuck out of that. And then maybe he'll grow a brain and he'll say, hey, I shouldn't have fucked with that Von Hilton guy.
This is why left him the
fuck
it.
Alone. And so will Troll Sainers and Naysayers, because they're all going to fucking jail too. Because if you think YouTube is going to go down the toilet without taking you fuckers with them, yeah, you're not thinking clearly, motherfucker. Because YouTube, I guarantee you that YouTube and Google will sing like a fucking canary, and that every goddamn one of you sons of bitches are going to go to fucking prison. I guarantee it. I guarantee it.
I'm exempt.
In fact, it wouldn't surprise me one bit if Prager University says, okay, now listen, here's the deal, Google and YouTube. If you tell us who's been doing all this shit, we'll let you go, or at least make your sentence a lot less. You don't think Google and YouTube would sing like a fucking canary at that? Oh, fuck yeah. You say, oh, that won't happen. Bullshit. Deals like that are made all the fucking time.
But aren't they made all the fucking time? Direction?
Are you listening to me,
like,
trolls?
Like, don't they catch the drug dealers?
Deals
the
like
drug
that are made all the time in court.
Dealers to catch the drug
and YouTube
pins?
And Google is going to sing like a fucking canary, and you sons of bitches are all going to go to federal prison. Watch it happen. Because YouTube and Google are not going to go down the shitter without taking you with them. And you better believe that shit. Because that's the truth. And so I'm going to have a great deal of fun watching you motherfuckers do the perp walk. I'm going to enjoy that shit. I'm going to enjoy it a lot.
Perps.
And it's long overdue. 10 years fucking with me and my family? 10 years? Yeah, that's not normal, bitch. There is nothing normal about that. Okay? There's nothing normal about that. So are you getting paid to do this shit? Of course you are. You're getting paid to terrorize me and my family. And as soon as this lawsuit kicks off, I guarantee you'll be implicated, because I'll make damn sure they got your info. I've already given them the Wall Street Journal all you guys' info.
The Wall Street Journal.
Oh, shit.
Sure have. I also give the Secretary of Treasury all of you guys' info. Sure have.
Can you imagine being some poor intern?
I've also notified the Attorney General.
Read that shit.
Right.
You sure have.
Would you even like want to present it to anybody? Like, is this even worth it?
You know, it depends on his mood, but he either was like so fucking pissed. Like, if he had to read it 3 hours overtime, scratching for a story, and he just frustratedly throws it in the trash can, yeah. Or he's like, look at this shit.
Right, yeah. Could be something there.
I sure have. I have notified the Attorney General to legally list you, Trolls, Haters, and Naysayers, and the Honor Network as Internet Terrorist Organizations. Literally. So now chew on that for a while, bitches. You want to destroy my family. You want to hurt my children. You want to harass the fuck out of me. You want to get my VidMe channel taken down. You want to fucking force me to close my YouTube channel so that I ain't got no fucking money.
Well.
Ends on the titties.
Ends on the titties.
Yeah, his titties were kind of coming in. You could see him developing. He was at a solid training bra right there. He's a B cup now, all the way. Full B.
Right.
I don't know, man. At least play one more good one. I think you got one more good one we can find.
Yeah, I just want to check out who's over here. Look at this comment.
Ronnie Ray, I just want to say, Ronnie's out there. You're the real MVP. Keep doing what you're doing. Keep on pushing the fans.
Ripped out. I'm just reading through some of the comments here. Well, thank you, everyone, for coming out tonight. See what's going on. What's going on? Yeah, there's Ronnie Ray, Mr. United. We got Queen Cat Lady. Gato Yato. Blue Devil. Moosey. Bobcat. Richie.
Bobcat was keeping it real over in D-Live today.
Oh, yeah?
Doing the Lord's work, reminding Vaughn that you are indeed a card-carrying member of the First Cav.
Association, yes. Your associate members. I don't know, folks. How you feeling out there? What are we looking at? What are we thinking? Fucking 3.5 hours now. Fuck it.
Let's get one more little dab at the old well here.
Well, that's
because you know that this to me this is the allure. You never know.
Yeah, I don't
what
know.
You're gonna find. You have no idea. Even and you do a very diligent job of labeling these. But I still feel like
they're all over the place. If someone requested a video, I wouldn't be able to find it right now. Like, I don't know where the fuck that is. Private listening session 4.
Wait, at the very top is the Andrea Safe House tapes. I just want to remind everybody that the full 8+ hours and all the skid marked glory that you've only seen maybe 30 minutes of, just want to remind you that there it is. That's literally the former arc of the Troll Covenant. You know, these days, the mouse interview is, you know, it's no big deal. I mean, shit. Mm. He's 2 steps from being homeless. Now, that's about the mouse interview's old news.
What do we got?
Dead fish rant?
Oh, that's when they were all washing up on the shore.
I remember that.
Alien sound.
Get the CPS folder. Von Hilton gravity.
Yeah, that's when one of his first dealings with Miss Parker, and he doesn't believe in gravity. That's pretty fucked up. How long?
You know,
it?
There was one, and I, you know, I'm sure it's lost to time, but the channel was like Snert, SNRT, and he had.
Yeah, I remember that.
Do you remember that he had tricked Bond into thinking he was talking to like a ghost hunting show?
Yeah.
That was a good one.
Yeah. We got the pedo calls.
So many of those have just been lost to time.
Got racist rants. Yeah, fucking
Andrea arresting Andrea. Yeah. Fucking mugshot.
Yeah.
2 and 3.
Yeah, we got a few.
Call on state troopers.
I got these vids too. What do I got in the rage folder? It's good to end with a little bit of rage.
Oh, yeah. Catfish. I don't care about the loss. That's a fucking keeper.
Yeah. That's a short one.
It's a good one, though. That's a good one. That's a keeper.
You got Kenny going to jail.
Right.
How long is that? A couple minutes.
Oh, the off-air ones are good, too.
Yeah, yeah. There's the Baby Jane versus Vaughn.
Von Elton loses his shit. 27 minutes.
We checked
stream.
That out earlier.
I know. I'm just laughing at the title. There's the Dr. Descent one right there with old Smoking Joe Trainer.
Yeah, but remember, I got to boost the volume.
Oh, yeah. So you know, I think that video is actually still on. I'll check.
Yeah, probably, but just the audio quality is so bad. I'd rather clean it up.
Uncle Sam versus Jesus. Sounds promising.
Oh, you guys remember that? We could check that out for a minute. This is one of these off-air things where Von starts ranting about religion.
Sure, tell me in the Mormon Bible, the Lutheran Bible, whatever Bible you got. Show me
haircut.
Where the disciples bowed down and worshiped
him. Yeah, the flat top.
That's the flat top there, folks.
That's built for speed,
some
baby.
Some of the videos we played tonight, it was a grown-out version of it. It was months later, and you couldn't really, but this is when it was still pretty fresh. He's got the fucking Kentucky flat top.
God.
27 minutes of screaming ASMR.
Right.
That's it.
Never find it. You will never find it because it didn't happen. It did not happen.
Really? Can you back that up?
It didn't happen. It really didn't happen. Sorry about your luck.
Vaughn, can you back that up? Can you back up what you said?
Yeah, because it's not in the Bible.
I just want to point out the name of the hangout is Peaceful, Friendly, No Drama.
It isn't even in the Gnostic Gospel.
Listen,
I just got done reading the book of I just got done reading the book of Thomas. Is there anywhere in the book of Thomas where they bowed down and worshiped Jesus? No. It's not in there. Sorry. I read the book of Enoch. In the book of Enoch where they bowed down and worshiped Jesus?
Hey,
no, it's not. Is it in the Bible? No, it's not.
Hey, Vaughn, do you know what Emmanuel means?
Hey,
Can I happen? Mm-hmm.
Go ahead.
Hey, do you know what I'm doing?
We've dropped off air, so we should probably head over to my room if we want to be live. I put a link to my hangout in the sidebar text chat. So,
sorry, Nadia, don't be trying to mute people and all that because you don't agree with
me. I don't know why Mr. Von is so upset all of a sudden. You know, it's like seeing some demon coming out of him.
Now you're getting it. You wanted confrontation.
What
now you're getting it.
Boy, I just asked you what
you wanted.
What
confrontation. No, you kept asking me the same damn question over and over. That's what you did.
So back
that's
up.
Did.
Back up your claim that Christ is not God.
Oh my God, dude.
Really?
Like I said, show me anywhere in the Gnostic Gospels or in the Bible itself where the disciples bowed down and worshipped him as a god. Show it to me.
Why do you have to, like, bow down anyway?
You're the one claiming he's God, not me, bro. I'm not claiming he's God. I'm claiming that he said, look to the Father. Look to the Father. Every time he opened his mouth, he said, look to the Father. He never once said, bow down and worship me. Not one time. Not once.
James, can I ask you? Would you say Jesus was an avatar? Would that perhaps fit your view?
Here's what Jesus is. Jesus is a reflection of what we can become if we're faithful to the gods. That's what Jesus is. Jesus is the embodiment of the power of God flowing through man. He succeeded
godly.
Where many other prophets had failed. And he is an embodiment of the power of God within us. And Jesus even said of his own mouth, when I come back, you will be like me. Well, now, wait a minute. If Jesus is God, does that mean I'm going to be a God too? Because that's what he said. He said, when he comes back, we're going to be like him. No, it doesn't mean we're going to be gods, little g. We're not going to be gods. Okay, we're not going to be gods. That would be blasphemy. Yeah. What does it mean?
But
the power of God flowing through us. Unadulterated power
mad.
Of God flowing through us to those who believe and will not falter. That's what it means. It doesn't mean to become a.
He's quite passionate about the Bible for a pagan.
I mean, isn't he though? Like he's like it's almost like everything he believes hinges on this one thing, and if you dare question it, right? Like you're besmirching his entire faith.
Oh yes.
God, it doesn't mean that we're all going to be playing harps. It doesn't mean any crap like that. It means the unadulterated power of God, the unlimited power of God flowing through mankind. That's what it means.
But James, do you believe in the resurrection?
I believe that Jesus Christ is Messiah, if that's what you're asking, yes.
No, the resurrection.
No, I do not. You don't have to be the deity
to be Messiah.
He doesn't believe
that Christ is Son of God.
You are the embodiment of the power of God on earth. But that doesn't necessarily mean... Listen, sir, would you agree with me that the Jews know more Hebrew than you and I do? Would you agree with me on that? Okay, the Jews know their own language. They know what Hebrew means. They know what Hebrew interprets. Okay, they're not believing that Christ is deity either.
Well, I tell you, if you're thinking about shutting her down, play us out with "I Don't Care About the Laws." That is a keeper from the old days. Close us out on that. I'm good for a couple more, but just when you close it out. Mm-hmm. Close it out with that one. Up to you. I can stay as little or as long as you like.
Well, I don't know what else. I mean,
Kenny going to jail is pretty good. How long is that one?
Excuse me. Sorry, folks.
While Hilton threatened someone.
Yeah, that's a newer one. And then affirming Vaughn his threats, rages... he comes in and doubles down on them here.
Nice, nice. Vaughn rages against the trolls.
Yeah. Yeah.
Last Team 4 hours. Crotch.
Yeah. Haters rant. Kenny going to jail. Everyone's going to jail. How long is this one? This is another backstage one where he's going on about religion. I don't know if I'll watch the whole thing, but I think just...
We'll just give it a peek.
No, I'm talking about on Earth.
No, that's what I mean. That's what I mean, on Earth. We'll never go away.
Rain on Earth.
Right.
Because this earth will be no more.
No, what it said was that there will be a rolling rain for 1,000 years, and Satan is loose for a season, and then after that, he's thrown into the pit, and everything just goes on hunky-dory. But the New Jerusalem isn't going to take off and leave Earth. It's staying here, bro.
Yes.
It's staying here.
That, yeah, we know that, you know, God will bind Satan for 1,000 years, and during the 1,000 years, Satan cannot deceive any nation anymore, and martyrs are resurrected to reign with Christ for 1,000 years. The rest of that will be raised at the end of 1,000 years, and those in the first resurrection will reign with Jesus for 1,000 years. And Satan will lose at the end of the 1,000 years. And
all I'm going to ask you is this. Will the kingdom of God be established on earth forever?
Listen. I'm trying to
just... You're going too long. That's 5 minutes for one answer. Will the kingdom of God be established on earth forever?
This guy, man.
Hey, James, how long do it take you to answer this? Will the kingdom of God be eventually established on earth forever?
The kingdom of God is...
With this guy.
It is infinite.
I'm not even...
Thank you, James. You just answered that question that took him 5 minutes to answer. Now, the kingdom of God that Christ was telling Nicodemus to be born again, he must see.
What do I know about Christ?
I didn't ask you about religion.
I was a Christian for over 35 years, bro.
I didn't ask you how long it's been, you idiot. What do you know about Christ?
How long is what been?
What do you know about Christ? What do you know about
the Bible? Is that what you're trying to tell me, sir? You're naivete of the Bible? You're going to tell somebody with 35 years of religious experience under his belt that you know more than I do? Don't.
Listen, I didn't ask you about some religious experience. I asked you what you know about Christ, you idiot.
What do I know about Christ? I'll tell you what I know about Christ. When Christ returns, he's going to look at you and he's going to say, "Depart from me, I never knew you." You know why he's going to say that? He's not going to say it necessarily because of the evils or goods that you've done in the past. Not of works.
Listen to my question. I didn't ask you what he's going to do.
First thing Jesus is going to do when he comes back is he's going to visit Von Helton. He's going to turn around to all the trolls and say, "Bailiff, take him away."
That's right. Enemies list, Von. Hand it to me. It's time.
Yet again, Von is quite passionate about faith that he claims he's not a part of.
And for someone who's a pagan, right, who serves the unnamed gods, he's pretty keen on the idea of Sheriff Jesus.
Yeah.
You know, going out there and smiting his foes.
I ask you what you know about Christ, you idiot.
Apparently, I don't know a damn thing, and you know everything, right, motherfucker? You just got all the fucking answers, right, bro?
That's not what I'm saying.
You got all the answers? Have you got all the answers, yes or no? Have you got all the answers, yes or no? It's a simple question.
Hey, don't go off topic, man. What do you know about price, man?
You asked me what I know. I said, what do you know? What do you know?
I'm asking you.
You're going to tell a man with 35 years of religious study under his belt that I'm a dumbass? Is that what you're saying? Is that what you're saying?
I'm not asking you about some religious experience.
I know a little bit more about the Bible than you do, son.
I'm not asking you.
20 years old? I was studying the Bible before you were even born.
Biblical knowledge.
You don't talk to me about shit, man. You got nothing to say to me. You don't.
What do you know about Christ? What do you know about Christ, man?
I just sat here and explained for the last 2 minutes.
I don't care about your religious experience.
Sam, the man knows all you, Sam.
Would you like to tell you all the stupid inerrancies that you people sat down and accepted because you listened to the Catholic Church instead of doing the research on your own? I can sit here all night and discuss that, brother.
You don't have to speak for me. You don't have to presume.
I'm not speaking
I simply asked you, what do you know about Christ?
Why in whom God has set free is free indeed. You don't even know what you're talking about.
On the monitor. Look at you. I have so mad.
I'm so behind a podium instead of doing the research for yourself.
Shades of Lone Wolf.
Were you mad, Vaughn? You mad?
You can't try to mock him. You can't try to mock him.
I'm not mad. I'm not mad.
What a wild and twisted world we got here. We got Vaughn and the Black Hebrew Israelite teaming up.
Yeah. Yeah.
This is some good shit.
Mandela effect, folks.
Get him a skinhead in there and we'll be ready.
See, this is the Vaughn from my star system. My quadrant of the galaxy. Right? This is what's been swapped.
Star Sector 6969.
God, he is fired up over this.
That haircut, dude, it's the haircut. It gives him power. Ugh. Look at him. He's fucking surly.
It's like the reverse Samson.
That's right.
He's going to smack you all upside the head and tell you that you're fool.
I didn't ask you what he would do after he's back. I asked you.
When he comes back, he's going to look you in the eye and he's going to say, I didn't know you. Not because of the evil that you've done. Not because of sin. He's
going to
tell you I never knew you because you created a new religion called Christianity that he never even wanted. He didn't want a new religion called Christianity. He wanted to abolish religion. He called him a den of vipers. He called them a bunch of snakes. He told them that they're a tomb of whitewashed bones. He didn't want no organized religion, bro.
Right.
Do you get it?
I think this fucking Jesus DiCaprio guy is about ready to fucking try to initiate Vaughn out to the corner.
Screaming
down there. See him and G-Man going head to head.
I think he needs to be introduced to the video made by Dr. Dwayne B. Michelob.
Yes.
You're not getting it, man. And you're going to get spanked hard, bro. When he comes back, you're going to get spanked hard. Because nobody's getting this shit. Except
I didn't ask you what he will do. I asked you, what do you know about Christ, you idiot?
Okay, you keep asking the same damn question. And I've already explained that I know who Christ is. So who do you think he is? Who do you think he is? And if you say he's God, I'm going to laugh at you. Because he never made that claim. Made that claim. The Apostle Paul made that claim for him. But he never said it. Unless you show me in red letters in that Bible where Jesus said, bow down and worship me, I am God, then I'm sorry, I can't follow you.
This guy's crazy.
You're going to hell.
That's right, James.
Not me, bro. Not me.
Why are you condemning people?
Because I have the fear of God.
Why are you condemning people like an idiot?
Temporary as it may be, he was still immortal, and I have a great fear of giving any more.
Why are you condemning people like an idiot?
Why are you sitting there asking me the same damn question over and over again when I've already answered it?
No, you didn't.
Yes, I did.
I'm
telling you.
No, you
that
didn't.
You are wrong.
No, you didn't.
That you have
you didn't.
Got
you
no
didn't
study
at all.
Whatsoever.
You can say whatever you want. Wow, you are very emotional, Vaughn.
You bet your ass I'm emotional.
What do you know about Christ, huh?
Because you wanted emotion, and you got it in spades.
What do you know about Christ, boy? Tell us.
Will you quit asking me the same damn question after I've already answered it? What do you know about Jesus?
Well, I didn't ask you about your experiences. I didn't ask you.
What do you know about Jesus? You ask me, I'll ask you. What do you know about Jesus?
Well, for example, I know Jesus is God in the flesh.
You do know he's God. Okay, well, then you're wrong. Sorry, you're wrong. Show me in the red letter edition of the Bible in red letters where Jesus said, listen, dummy. Stop and listen for a second. Peter approached Jesus and he said, thou art the Christ. Thou art the Son of the living God. Jesus should have said, if Jesus really was God, Jesus would have said, okay, bow down and worship me. He didn't. He didn't. He did not say it. He did not say it, sir. He had the perfect opportunity to say that, and he didn't do it. Why? Because he said, look to the Father. Look to the Father. Look to the Father.
That's right.
He never once said, bow down and worship me. He never once said that.
That's a screamer.
He had the perfect opportunity. Peter said, thou art the Christ. And Jesus should have said, okay, I am the Christ. Bow down and worship me. They never did it. They never bowed down and worshiped
him.
They never did it. Mm-hmm. Show me in the Bible. Show it.
Lay us out, Tony.
He's quite passionate. Quite passionate, folks. 35 years experience. All right. I don't care about the lulls. Let's do it.
Here we go, folks. Gird your loins,
okay,
ladies.
I don't give a fuck about your excuses. I don't give a fuck about your reasoning. I don't give a fuck about the laws. I don't give a fuck about the fucking laws. I don't give a fuck about the fucking laws.
This is such a good quality
video. I'll beat your ass. That's why none of these fuckers are brave enough to come to my house. Because they know I'll kick their fucking ass. And my wife will record it and post it to YouTube. You think the cops are going to protect you, asshole? I guarantee I get two or three good licks in before they stop me. Guarantee that shit, because I'm a quick motherfucker. Go watch that video of the old man on the bus, and that young black dude kept harassing the fuck out of him. Yeah, what happened to the young black dude? He got his ass beat, didn't he? Come to my house and try that shit. Try the shit you're trying now here on the internet in front of my house and see what happens to you. I'll beat your fucking ass. I don't give a fuck. Who cares? I don't care about the police. I don't care about... I went to my local police. My local police blew me off. I went to the district attorney. He blew me off, too. So now if the state police blow me off, then I'm coming after you myself. And you don't want that. Trust me. Because if I come after you, I will arrest your ass. And I hope you resist. Get on the internet, and if I can find out somebody's personal information, I can get CPS called on them. I can get their business ruined. I can get their siblings killed, their wife killed.
What?
Nobody's going to do jack shit. Not a soul. Not a peep. Nobody's going to do nothing. Do you think anybody did an investigation on why my wife's oxygen was cut off? Nope. No. That's left now to do is to go after the trolls. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to see how much it costs to get a bounty hunting license and
here
go
we
through
go.
Whatever hoops they want me to go through so that when I knock on your door, troll, I'll be legal, okay? And if you resist arrest, I'll be legal to bust your ass, too, okay? That way you can't whine, he's a vigilante. You won't be able to whine that shit because I'll be legal when I knock on your door. I'm already looking into what I need to do to be totally legal
if you're out there.
In all 50 states of the union. Since everybody has blown me off, I'm coming after you myself. I will find out. There has to be somebody that knows how to get your information. You trolls, you haters on Delphi and YouTube and whatever. I'm going to find out where you live. I'm going to knock on your door. And we're going to handle matters our way. Because the police don't want to help me. District attorney don't want to help me. State police don't want to help me. So it looks like I'm going to have to deal with the trolls by myself. So be prepared for a knock on the door by me. Okay, you're going to be facing me. And I ain't going to be playing, and I ain't going to be laughing. Because when I get done, there won't be anything left. Okay? You'll never get on the internet again, I guarantee you, when I get done. Kill 12-year-olds. So, if they're coming at me with a knife, I'm well within my right to kill them. Because it's either them or me at that point, dumbass.
I can kill children.
But you go on ahead and you post your little hate video about me. Go ahead. Because I don't give a fuck.
now that the FBI has blown me off, as well as the state police and the local police, I'm coming for you myself. It looks like I don't have a choice now.
Botog, if you're out there and you're listening, Chili Dogs by the Vaughn presents I Am the Vaughn, the Big Bad Vaughn, the Bounty Hunter. I mean, just, it writes itself, man. It writes itself.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. It's out there. Well, folks, I think we are just coming up to 4 hours. I think that is enough for tonight. Thank you for joining me on this deep, deep dive into the vault. Oh, there's more. There's so much more, but we'll have to do it again another day.
Shout out to the Frost. Keeping it real in the streets out there. Yeah.
Doing the God's work. But, all right, I think that's where I'm going to end it. So, you don't have to go home, but you can't stay here. Get the fuck out. Peace.